every fire within you lights to defend against it. Coming off of a holiday break, Fordham will now continue their homestand as they welcome Harvard, a team they haven't beaten in four of their last five tries. The last time Fordham downed the Crimson, Harvard was the 22nd ranked team in the country back in December 2012. The Rams look to steer clear of the Ivy League power and remove the thorn from their side, but it won't be pretty against a tough Tommy Amaker-led team. It's Fordham and Harvard, live from the Rose Hill Gym, next on WFUV Sports. Welcome into a special day here at Fordham Men's Basketball, live on WFUV Sports alongside Mike Calamari. I'm Thomas Aiello, and Mike, beyond the fact that Fordham is playing Harvard today, it's a very special day here at Rose Hill, as today the court will be enshrined in the name of the great Frank McLaughlin, who's given over six decades of service to this school.
Yeah, and you really think about special names in Fordham athletics history, Jack Coffey, Vince Lombardi, Frank McLaughlin right there with them, and it's a special day, and I think we're all really excited to see a well-deserved enshrinement for him as he gets his name named after the court here at the Rose Hill Gym.
Well, all of his friends and family are here today as we're just about to get started for Fordham and Harvard momentarily, but we're going to send it to our interview that we had with Coach Ergo earlier today as he talked about the matchup today between Fordham and Harvard.
Coach, today you guys are playing host to Harvard, a team that has historically dominated the Ivy League in the last decade plus. Now they come in off an injury-riddled season with Tommy Amaker still at the head coaching spot. What do you think of their team coming into the Rose Hill Gym today?
Yeah, Coach Amaker is one of my favorite coaches in the country. He always has been since the days I was a high school coach at Gonzaga. He always treated me well. Recruited one of our kids, Max Kenyi, who ended up playing for him. So I've had great respect for Coach Amaker. He's done just an incredible job at Harvard, built a ridiculous program that's been extremely successful. So, you know, they're very well coached, very disciplined, extremely tough and physical. Obviously, Ledlam is one of the better players that will play all year long, regardless of league. So we have to be prepared. They do a great job on the offensive glass. They don't turn the ball over. You know, they really are well coached and disciplined, so especially in their sets. So we have to be very disciplined on the defensive end and be tough and physical on the offensive glass.
Coach, you guys had a really long layoff since last week. You've had about five or so days to take some time off, have a little Thanksgiving, but now you guys are back at it. Is that much of a concern for you, or do you think that everyone is still in the rhythm that they were after the final game of the Konchalski Classic?
No, I think those couple days off were vital for us. Three games in 4 days, no matter what the situation is always taxing on the body. And it showed that Tuesday night against Stonehill, we were dragging a little bit, so That couple days was very necessary for us to get healthy, have a little bit of healing on some of our bruises. And we had two great days of practice, which is always important when you got a bunch of young guys that are looking to contribute. So I'm hoping the rest will help us out a lot. I think our guys are ready to go today.
Coach, good luck on the game today.
Thanks so much.
Well, you heard Coach Ergo on that interview. This Harvard team is nothing to rather shy away from. They're a really, really good team, really competitive team, but Fordham, Mike, really likes the challenge. And Tommy Amaker in his 16th year, he's made stops at Duke as a player. He was with Coach Krzyzewski for a while, then he was at Michigan, then he was at Seton Hall, and now he's at Harvard in his 16th year, and he's built a serious Ivy League power.
Yeah, and I think this is going to be one of Fordham's biggest challenges they've had yet so far in the non-conference schedule. You think back to, of course, number 10 University of Arkansas, but they have had a series of some easier opponents, some tougher opponents. UIC, one of those tougher opponents, a close game. They're coming off of a 71-60 win over Stonehill. But this is a Harvard team that matches their 5-1 record. Their only loss coming their second game of the season to the University of Louisiana. They've then gone on a four-game winning streak, including taking down fellow Atlantic 10 rival newly joined Atlantic 10 team, Loyola University Chicago. So this is going to be a great game. Harvard is always in it in the Ivy Leagues, and they have a history of beating a lot of teams in the non-conference schedule. This is going to be a great one and a good test for Fordham.
Well, last year they were just so injured to every team, every player on the team. Only four guys played in all of the games last year, but this year the Crimson looking to get back to their class status that they were in that in the entire 2010s decade. Pretty much the whole decade, they were kind of running shop in the Ivy League. But for this Fordham team, the three games in 4 days, that one could probably argue is about as much of a challenge as playing a team like an Arkansas in such a short amount of time.
Yeah, and I think they've learned a lot over that time. We talked to Coach Paulson. They saw three different defenses over those three games. Really, all each team had their own way of attacking Fordham defensively. I think Fordham's learned a lot from that experience. They've obviously struggled turning the ball over the season, averaging 17 turnovers per game. That's bottom 50 in the country. But they're going to come into this one after a nice break, 5 days to regroup, reset themselves, and they're going to work to try to limit the turnovers. That's going to be the big one for them in this one. If they can limit those turnovers, then they're going to be in a good position against Harvard.
Well, also limiting the turnovers, defending the three-pointer is what's going to be key today for Harvard. Right now, they're one of the best perimeter defensive teams in the entire NCAA, and they're also 50th in the NCAA in field goal percentage at 48.9. Just an incredibly efficient shooting team. As we take a look at the starting lineups, first for the Crimson, Lucas Sakota, Chris Ledlam, who last game dropped 30-9, Evan Nelson, Sam Silverstein, and Justin Ajogbar are the two big. So Harvard going with a interesting lineup, a hybrid forward and a rather traditional big, and three guards who are really going to light it up from the perimeter, Mike.
Yeah, and it's Chris Ledlam, that's the guy, averaging over 20 points per game. Coming into this game, Fordham faced a lot of 1-2 punches. This is the first team they're playing where it's really a star they're going to have to defend.
And for Fordham, they're opening five, Darius Quisenberry, Kyle Rose, Antrell Charlton, Khalid Moore, and Abdu Simbila. Nothing has changed through these first six, now seven games for this Fordham team. And we've echoed it the entire season so far, Mike. Continuity is king.
Khalid Moore coming over 24 points last game on 9 of 13 shooting. He's the guy that is the cog in this offense next to Darius Quisenberry. Those two guys, but Khalid Moore, can he rebound? Can he continue what he started last time against Stonehill?
So Harvard in their away crimson red with black striping as they win the tip. Fordham in their home white. And Evan Nelson will walk this up at the block F for Harvard. Swing pass far wing. This is Silverstein inside to Ajogbar and Simbila. Cross paint pass to Nelson. Hands back off on the right wing, driving to drive down the middle. Silverstein now pushes the free throw line. 11 on the shot clock. Nelson directs traffic, a high screen by Ajogbar. Swing pass, Silverstein, right wing. Off the side of the rim, ball tipped around. Quisenberry and Simbila go after it, and Fordham eats the defensive board up. Khalid Moore near sideline, pushing right to left. Harvard likes to play a high man-to-man zone. They like to pick everyone up at half court. Quisenberry with a screen and roll, drives the right baseline, bounce past Simbila, and he's fouled. So the big fella will go to the free throw line.
And how about Darius Quisenberry there? What we learned a lot about him at the Tom Kochelski Classic is not that he has not only that he has the ability to score, but also the ability to distribute the ball. Combined 14 assists over the last two games he's played. He's been giving up the ball very well, 8 assists in one game, 6 in another. He's been consistent. Finds Simbila there under the basket, sends him to the line.
So Abdu Simbila will go to the line for two here as he scores the first basket of the game, 1-0 Fordham. Last game he had 12 rebounds, only 4 points, but if he can continue rebounding the ball, he could be one of the best defensive players in the Atlantic 10.
And that's something Coach Urgo's talked about. He sees Abdu Simbila really becoming that defensive beast in the paint and also the ability to score at times on the offensive end.
So both free throws go down. It's 2-0, just about 50 seconds played in the first half. Silverstein at the block F, moving left to right for the Crimson. Hand off far side for Sakota, defended by Quisenberry. Harvard moving that ball around on the top half of the perimeter. Ledlam double-teamed by Charlton and Moore. Now Silverstein left wing driving. Free throw line J for Ajogbar is short. Well, offensive board collected by Silverstein on the right wing. Entry feed right block for Ajogbar, defended by Simbila. Going to work with a spin and a hook shot for two. So Justice Ajogbar knots things up. We're about a minute and a half here into the first half.
And a great move there by the Harvard Big man takes it into the paint, then hooks around on the block and gets the hook shot over Simbila.
Quisenberry right wing crossing over. Tries to work into a back now. And high post entry on the right block for Simbila. And stripped and stolen by Chris Ledlam under the basket.
And he takes it into the paint there, right into the hands of Chris Ledlam. He's able to strip it away.
Sakota tries to drive middle. Far corner, this is Silverstein. Inside, intercepted by Moore, but this one will stay with the Crimson.
And a nice job there by Harvard moving that ball around. This is a team that likes to move the ball, over 10 assists per game this season. So that's something Fordham's going to have to do, defend off the ball very well today.
Silverstein near side, right elbow extended. Swing pass to the far wing for Nelson, defended by Charlton. Screen coming by Ajogbar, now rolling. Under the basket, Silverstein rifles one, swarmed by Fordham Rams, and this one will stay here with the Crimson. Just over 2 minutes played. You see the Crimson, Mike, just really getting after it offensively.
And it's the size. This is one of the bigger teams Fordham's had to play all year. They're going to have to adjust defensively.
It's almost like they're disguised as an Atlantic 10 team. As this one is chucked up by Silverstein, rebounded by Khalid Moore. Fordham looking to push, rifles it under the basket for Simbila for the slam.
That is a great job by Fordham pushing in transition, exactly what they need to do after they get the rebound.
Nelson defended by Rose far wing, drives the left lane inside a Jogbar. He's fouled by Kyle Rose, who kicked his foot into the Jogbar's chest. And it seems to be okay.
Well, Jogbar's been tough so far early in this one for Crimson. Coming into this game, just over 3 points per game. He was shooting under 40% from the field. But they're making an emphasis on getting him the ball. That's clear from the outset of this one. And he's a weak free throw shooter under 50%. But if he keeps getting to the free throw line, it's going to be tough for Fordham, especially as they enter the bonus.
Jogbar goes for his first trip to the line. First one is good, so 4-3 now Fordham, 2.5 minutes played. Justice Ajogbar, the junior, hailing from Nigeria. Incredibly physical physical forward under the basket for the Crimson. As the second free throw goes in, so two go down for the Crimson. We're even at four, just over 3.5 played.
And Ajogbar already tying his season high of 4 points in just 3 minutes into this one.
Charlton high screen from Simbila. Swing pass Quisenberry top circle. Charlton working that left wing on Silverstein. Drives the left lane with a pump fake. Kicks it out. Rose a right wing three ball. And that goes down for Kyle Rose. 7-4 now Fordham. 3 minutes played.
Great ball movement from Fordham. That's what you want to see. Don't turn over the ball. Keep it safe. But find your guys on the perimeter for open shots.
Double team on that left corner on Nelson. Pick pass to Jogbar, left elbow. Opposite pass, Silverstein from the right wing, off the side of the rim. Offensive board by Nelson under the basket, rejected by Simbila. Sends it back, and here comes Fordham the other way, with Quisenberry at the top of the block F. 20 on the shot clock, high screen by Simbila. Right wing Quisenberry. Floater off the side of the backboard, rebounded by Nelson. The Crimson pushing down the middle with Nelson galloping. This one goes off of Ledlam's chest, and Harvard turns it over.
And just, I'm unsure about that pass selection there by Nelson. He had a lot of open teammates on the perimeter right there. He could have kicked it out, had a nice shot there, but he tries to sneak a pass in there to Ledlam, and good defense by Fordham. They're doing a really good job early on protecting that paint.
7-4, the Rams are up. Approaching 4 minutes played in the first half. Will Richardson has come in. And for Harvard, Eden Traitu has come in. Charlton on the left wing, crossing over Ledlam. Straight on Will Richardson, the pump fake. Back to Charlton, cutting down the middle. Richardson finds Nowitzki on the right block. Turnaround junior hook is no good. And Ajogbar with a rebound.
And here's a good chance for Harvard. Trail by three early on. Move in transition. Try to get a good offensive possession here.
Hand off to Nelson on this right wing. High screen by Ajogbar, crossing over. Driving that right block area. Bounce pass to Ajogbar, 8 feet from the hoop. Drives on Nowitzki, turning. Throws him to the floor, nothing there. Silverstein, the O-board under the basket. Near corner, Nelson, defended by Quisenberry with a fresh 20 on the shot clock.
And the Crimson, they're seeing the Fordham defense, and they want to enter into that paint score there with Ajogbar.
Trey 2, fading from 5 feet. Rebound, Charlton. 4.5 played here in the first half. Still 7-4 Fordham. Charlton goes to the left block, posting up Nelson. Throws up an interesting shot. Oborn, Nowitzki, Quisenberry, far wing. No good, and rebounded by Ledlam. Double teamed by Charlton and Moore, and they pickpocket Ledlam. Hand off to Quisenberry on the far corner. 5 minutes played here in the first half. Charlton, a far corner three, well short, rebounded by Ledlam. Harvard's going to look to push as Nelson brings it up. Still 7-4 Fordham. High screen by Ajogbar. Nelson, lollipop pass to Ledlam on the left block, and a foul here will go against Fordham. 7-4 is the score. The Rams are up on the Harvard Crimson. Just about 5 or so minutes played here in the first half. You're listening to Fordham Men's Basketball on WFUV Sports.
What's up, everyone? I'm Danny Scott.
I'm Tyler Hu, and we're two of your hosts for WFUV's College Gridiron.
We'll discuss all the best games from around the world of college football.
We'll also talk about the rankings and give our thoughts on the Heisman race.
We'll preview the best games of next week and give our score predictions.
Keenan Troy and other co-hosts will join us as well.
Tune in to College Gridiron wherever you get your podcasts.
Hey everyone, this is Darius Quisenberry, guard for your Fordham Rams. You can listen to us all season long over on 90.7 FM, WFUV Sports, and YouTube Live. WFUV Sports, the flagship station of Fordham Athletics.
Welcome back to our coverage of Fordham men's basketball here on WFUV Sports alongside Mike Calamari. I'm Thomas Aiello. Fordham's jumped out to an early 7-4 lead, just about 5 minutes and 15 seconds played here in the first half, Mike, and we're usually accustomed to seeing Fordham really trying to ramp up the pace, but they're going at one that could maybe be characterized as a power walk, if you will, in these early stages.
Yeah, and it's been definitely a back and forth early on. Hard to really categorize anything specific going on, just way too early. But you think about some things coming into this game. This is a Harvard team that doesn't really take too many threes, only 5.7 per game, and that's bottom 100 in the NCAA, 300 first to be exact. And they only take 18.8 three-point attempts. So they make 5.7, only 18.8 three-point attempts. And you're seeing that on display. They're trying to score inside the paint early, and they're trying to attack the Fordham 5 in Sambila and Nowitzki. That's going to be the game plan here for the Crimson offensively. But they just need to convert. Ajogbar has had some chances, only 1-for-3 from the field. He hasn't been able to always cash in. Besides him, no one's been able to score. They're 1-for-8 from the field. So Fordham's been doing a really good job defensively, but they're going to try to figure out how to adjust right now. The shots aren't falling, but they will. How can we keep them out of the paint and force them to take perimeter shots?
Well, Harvard right now is 1-of-8 from the field, Fordham 2-of-7. So both field goal percentages, 29 and 13 respectively, if you're rounding up. So it's definitely not an offensive special here in the first few minutes, but see if that will change as both teams take the court. Harvard will have it underneath the basket on the near side. Silverstein will inbound. Romad Dean has come in for Fordham, along with Will Richardson. Under the basket, Ledlam, and he gets a free layup for two.
Great inbounds play there by Crimson, and just a missed assignment there by Fordham. Let him sneak right into the left block and have a wide open layup.
So 7-6 now is the Fordham lead. High screen by Nowitzki. Quisenberry drives right, high off the glass. And he'll go to the line for two.
And Thomas, he's just so good there, just driving to the basket with his right hand. The amount of times we've seen Darius Quisenberry being able to get to that right block in motion and go high off the glass with a chance to make it, get to the free throw line here. But he's just so quick and he's so athletic that he's able to get into that position really whenever he wants.
So Quisenberry's first free throw is good. 93% free throw shooter on the year so far.
And he's struggled at times over the last two games, only 6-for-23 from the field against Stonehill and Holy Cross, but he's been able to help the team in other ways, and this could be the game where he really starts to get back into the offensive groove.
Both free throws go down. It's now a four-point lead, or three-point lead, excuse me. Just about 6 minutes played here in the first half. High side is Trey two. Hand off to Silverstein, left wing. Trying to drive on Kyle Rose down the middle. Extends the arm. Swing past Ledlam on the right block. Posting up Quisenberry. Double teaming over his Rose. Backdoor cut for Silverstein for two.
I mean, that's a beautiful pass in motion. They love to pass when they're already inside the paint. That's what makes them so effective offensively.
Rose pulls a right wing three. In and out. Rebounded by Ledlam. Sakota. Lob pass for Silverstein, right side. Defended by Ramad Dean. Swing pass into the corner for Chizumok Parr on the right block, posting up Kyle Rose. Trey 2 on the far corner, defended by Richardson. Pass out to Sakota, 10 on the shot clock. 6.5 played here in the first half.
And we've seen Harvard take down that shot clock a lot already.
Sakota off the back iron, and Dean tracks the board down. Still a one-point lead for Fordham. Here comes Quisenberry on the near side. Trying to take Sakota one-on-one. Entry pass to Vitsky on the left block. We're going to have a reach and foul against Silverstein. So Fordham will have this under the basket.
And it's a different offense we're seeing with the Crimson. Taking its time, trying to get inside the paint. And they're really led by one star in Ledlam. But early on, that has not been the story. He's had his impact. You think about that assist on the previous possession. But they've done a good job offensively, but once they get him going, they're going to be tough to stop.
So Nowitzki takes the inbound on the near corner. Elijah Gray just checking in with Khalid Moore. So Quisenberry and Dean will sit. Down the middle is Kyle Rose. Just about 7 minutes played here in the first half. Still 9-8 Fordham. Rose drives to his southpaw. Swing pass, far corner, Khalid Moore. High arcers off the top of the backboard. Rebounded by Sakota, and here come the Crimson. High screen by Silverstein. Stopped at the top. Now here comes Trey 2 down the right lane. Trying to get past Richardson. Muscles his way inside for a reverse layup for 2. And Harvard takes a 10-9 lead.
And an interesting lineup here with Richardson and Rose really as the two ball handlers. Rarely sees Charlton and Quisenberry both not on the floor.
Elijah Gray on the right wing. He'll pull a 3 ball. This is well short. Tipped around and Sakota comes up on the near side. Harvard looking to push. Crossing over down the middle. Sakota. Nothing for him. And this one will go out of bounds. Back to Fordham.
We've talked about the half-court offense of the Crimson already, but when they get moving in transition, they get moving downhill, they can score really well attacking that basket. So they present problems offensively, and you know, you see Antro Charlton check in probably to provide that ball handling and also that defensive versatility, but both teams are going to have to make adjustments in this one.
So Charlton will walk it up, as Mike said. It's about 8 minutes played here in the first half. High side Nowitzki, Quisenberry straight on with a pump fake. In and out move with a little floater, and that one's well short, an air ball. Harvard now pushing. Trey 2 on the near sideline. Defended by Quisenberry. Switched on to by Nowitzki. Kick out near corner. This is Okpara, defended by Charlton. Trying to get past him and help side. Nowitzki blocks the dunk attempt. Fordham in transition. Quisenberry down the right lane. And an offensive foul drawn by Trey 2 on Quisenberry.
I mean, what a series of events. One of the best defensive plays we've seen from the Fordham team this year, and especially from Rostek Nowitzki, but unable to cash, and now Harvard ball again.
10-9 is the score. The Crimson are up on the Rams, just under 12 to go in the first half. Let's send it to a one-on-one scoreboard with Will Jing.
The one-on-one scoreboard.
Today is Sunday, which means football is on today. A bunch of games started at 1 today, including the local New York Jets against the Chicago Bears. The Jets are currently down 10-7. Neither team has their starting QB, as Zach Wilson has been benched for the Jets after poor performances this season and lack of taking accountability, and Justin Fields has been benched for the Bears due to injury. Mike White is out there for the Jets, and Trevor Siemian is currently out there for the Bears. But Zach Wilson may eventually return to the lineup, as Robert Saleh said he wants a young quarterback to work on his fundamentals and get better during this time. Other games include a Super Bowl 50 rematch between the Broncos and Panthers, where the Panthers are up 7-3. Tom Brady's Bucks are down to the Cleveland Browns 10-7. The Ravens are playing the Jags in a battle of two young QBs, where Baltimore is up 3-0. The one-win Texans trail by 10 against the Miami Dolphins. The Jamar Chase-less Bengals are facing the Titans, where only the Titans have scored. They currently have 3 points. and the Falcons are playing the Commanders. It's currently 10-7 Falcons. In other football news, Aaron Rodgers is currently dealing with a right thumb fracture and one of the worst seasons of his career so far. He may need surgery and hopefully he heals up fast. Another star, Odell Beckham Jr., is currently in the news as he's meeting with the Giants, Cowboys, and Bills to determine his next landing spot. With WFUV Sports, I'm Will Jing.
Welcome back to the historic Rose Hill Gym. Alongside Mike Calamari, I'm Thomas Aiello for our coverage of Fordham Men's Hoops on WFUV Sports. 10-9, Harvard is up on the Rams. Just under 12 minutes to go here in the first half. And Mike, it's really been a back and forth affair. Fordham's been scoreless in the last 2 minutes and 45 seconds, and Harvard only 1-4 in their last 4 field goal attempts.
And it's a game of runs, as they say. Fordham scoreless in their last 2 minutes and 46 seconds. They've made one basket out of their last 10 attempts. They need offense, and they need it in a big way, but Harvard, they're still struggling offensively. They really haven't been able to pull ahead and take advantage of Fordham's missed opportunities. This is going to be a defensive battle from all the signs early on in the first 10 minutes.
Tommy Amaker is about as accomplished as they come, especially at the mid-major level. Had success with Seton Hall as a head coach, with Shaheen Holloway, as well as Michigan, had some good runs there, and now here he is at Harvard, coaching a very tough brand of Crimson Hoops. At the top of the circle is Hemmings, right wing, this is Trey 2. Okpar on the left wing, he'll pull a 3. This one's off, offensive board. Hemmings off the side of the backboard and the foul against Nowitzki. So Josh Hemmings, who's just checked in, will go to the free throw line.
And Fordham, they're letting the Crimson take that shot, which is great, but you have to be able to crash in the board. You have to be able to get the rebound. Don't give Harvard second chance opportunities. It's a team that they're pretty good on the offensive boards if they've given the opportunity and you don't box out. But I like the game plan early on from Fordham. Let them take those outside shots.
So Hemmings, the southpaw, will go to the line off the side of the rim. Josh Hemmings, the junior from Toronto, Ontario. Silverstein checks in, as well as Tyler Simon for the Crimson. Chris Ledlam is not on the floor, so perfect opportunity to strike if you're the Rams. And Simon's second free throw is off, so an empty trip. Rebound by Charlton, and here comes Fordham. The top of the circle, and this one's deflected by Hemmings, but this one will stay with the Rams.
And Fordham's doing a really good job taking care of the ball. They had 2 turnovers here in the first 9 minutes. A little deflection there, but you definitely see they are making an extra effort to be safe when they make those passes.
So Rose inbounds to Charlton. He'll walk this up. Just about 9 minutes to go here in the first half. Still a 10-9 lead for Harvard. Around a curl screen comes Khalid Moore with a pump fake on the left baseline. Gets into his post up on the left block. Swing pass, Charlton with 6 on the shot clock. To the right lane, pump fake. Kick pass, Khalid Moore. Swing pass, Kyle Rose. A straight on 3. Nothing there. And Okpara with the rebound under the board.
I think offensively, Fordham just getting a little too cute right now. Just go up with what you're under the basket.
Trey 2 with a strong move and tipped out to Simon. He'll pull a right wing 3 off the side of the rim. Rebounded Abdu Simbila with authority. Fordham now pushing with Quisenberry on the right side. Crossover to Charlton. 9.5 played here in the first half, as Kyle Rose gets the loose ball, drives that left lane, gets inside with his left, rejected by Okpara, and Hemmings with it. Here comes Harvard now with Trey 2 pushing that middle end of the floor. Swing pass, far corner, Silverstein, skip pass to Simon on the near wing, now to Trey 2 at the top of the circle. Halfway through half number one. Still 10-9 Harvard. Trey 2 on the right wing, trying to take Simbila one-on-one, gets inside. Silverstein throws it up and he's fouled. So Sam Silverstein will go to the free throw line for his second trip.
And a great job there, but you're getting inside the paint and then finding Silverstein cutting to the basket. They make so many good off-ball cuts, even when they're already at the basket. That's something that's hard to defend, and that's why they're getting to the line so much early in this one.
So Sam Silverstein will go to the free throw line, the junior from Glencoe, Illinois. His first free throw is good. So beats his point total from last game against Loyola Chicago now with three, and he had two that last game. As Hemmings and Simon will sit down as Jodbar comes back in for Harvard, well as Evan Nelson. So one more for Silverstein, and this one is good. So the Crimson now up 12-9, 10 minutes exactly left in half number one. Charlton will walk this up at the top. Fordham opens their motion, hand off to Quisenberry. He'll pull a straight on three ball, and we're tied at 12. Near corner, it's Silverstein defended by Charlton. Driving now is Trey 2 down the right lane. Rejected from behind by Rose. Saved by Rose, and here comes Fordham. Kyle Rose pushing the middle of the floor. Head fake move, throws up with the right hand, nothing there. Trey 2 with the rebound. Here come the Crimson looking to run. Far side Nelson, picked off by Quisenberry. Falls down, ball's loose. Charlton comes up with it, but a kick ball called by the officials, and this one will go back to Harvard.
And Quisenberry laughing a bit there. He thought he maybe was able to really, really take away this momentum. Gets the steal, but just loses the handle and ends up falling to the floor. The only thing he could do is really try to kick it to his teammate, Anshel Charlton.
Well, it's a acceptable time to kick because the World Cup is in right now. As Trey 2 with the inbound at the top. 9 minutes to go here in the first half. Trey 2 with a little shoulder bump on Quisenberry. Left side is Okpara on Charlton. Drives the left lane, gets inside. Simbila throws it back. Ajogbar the O board. Swarmed by Rams. And Khalid Moore turns in the jump ball, and this one will go Fordham's way as we have some beef going on. Uh-oh. As Okpara and Quisenberry getting in on it.
And the ref's going to bring two players together, Okpara and Simbila. Looked like there could have been a bit of a stare down after that, but it was really hard to tell with everything going on inside the paint. But looks like everything is settled down. It's going to be Fordham going from right to left.
So 9 minutes to go here in the first half. It's 12 all. A little bit of a scuffle after that last sequence, but that's good for a game that's been slow to start as Will Richardson walks it up for Fordham. Bounce pass to Charlton and just underneath the half-court mark. Back to Quisenberry, right wing. 8:50 to go here in this first half. Quisenberry drives right. Bounce pass for Simbila, can't hang on. Dives on the ball. And they're going to call a travel here as he got up. And this one will go back to Harvard.
Simbila was on the floor there. He basically just tries to stand up with the ball. And that's where the travel call comes from. But this game is starting to get physical. When you have a team that likes to attack the inside of the paint to score their baskets, that's the result you're going to have.
Sakota and Quisenberry picking up 94 feet. Nelson here on the right wing. Now drives down the left side. Kick pass, far corner, Silverstein. Hits a three. Sam Silverstein puts the lead back up to three. 8:30 to go in the first half.
And a rare three from him, only shooting 25% from the three-pointer so far this year.
Khalid Moore on the left wing, handoff to Charlton. Played by Silverstein. Quisenberry will pull a straight on three. And answers right back. We're tied up at 15. 8 minutes to go now in the first half.
Something Coach Ergo talks about, getting him involved in the offense off the ball.
Loose ball, Richardson dives, and Fordham comes up with it. Quisenberry at the right wing, pulls back. And Fordham opens up their offensive set. South of 8 minutes to go in the first half. Quisenberry. Khalid Moore backing down on the right block on Ledlam. Turning, hooking, nothing there. Rebounded by Nelson. Here comes Harvard. Straight on as Nelson pulls up off the back of the rim. Simbila skies for the board. Far sideline, Quisenberry. Crossing over on Nelson. Pulls back at the free throw line, and they're going to call a foul on the floor here against Harvard. And this will send us to another media timeout. 15 all, Fordham and Harvard. 7:23 to go in the first half. You're listening to Fordham Men's Basketball on WFUV Sports.
What's going on, everyone? This is Danny Scott, your New York Jets beat reporter.
Join me all season long for updates, features, and analysis as the Jets young core looks to take flight. Follow me on Twitter, dscott_33, or check out our WFUV Sports YouTube page for all things Jets.
It's 90.7 WFUV New York. Listener-supported public media from Fordham, the Jesuit University of New York. On air, online, and always commercial-free.
Welcome back inside the historic Rose Hill Gym for our coverage of Fordham men's basketball on WFUV Sports. Alongside Mike Calamari, I'm Thomas Aiello. Here on Frank McLaughlin Day, as the Fordham floor will be enshrined in his name. It's Fordham and Harvard going at it, 15-all here. 7:23 to go in the first half. I mean, Mike, this game has been quite the opposite of what I thought it was going to be coming in. I thought it was going to be a fast-paced, high-scoring game, but we're only at 15 each for both teams, and there's 7 minutes to go in the first half.
Harvard 5-for-20 from the field. That's 25%. Fordham 4-for-17. That's just over 23%. Both teams have hit 4 free throws, so that's where, you know, some of their points are coming from. They're not coming from the field, and it's been a defensive game. It's been a physical game, and that's what you're going to expect to see moving forward. We talked about how Fordham was kind of in a stale part of their offense in that early on first half. Now as we enter with 7 minutes left in the first half, Harvard, they're 1-for-their-last-8, 1-for-their-last-7 from three. So the lack of offense is going both ways. Both teams are not able to capitalize on the other team's missed opportunities.
Also could be Mike. Fordham, from their side especially, 3 games in 4 days. You get a pretty sizable layover from Thanksgiving to now. And that maybe could perhaps be playing a little bit of a factor into this game. There's perhaps some fatigue. Maybe guys aren't as sharp as you would expect them to be. And that goes for both teams. But that could be an underlying factor, especially in the waning moments of this game later on.
And I think you see the energy. Both these teams haven't played in, you know, Harvard has played more recently than Fordham, but the energy is there with both these teams, but the shooting is not as crisp as we saw it during the Top Kachalsee Classic, at least for the Fordham Rams.
So more inbounds on the far side to Nowitzki. Quisenberry with a swing pass, Charlton at the top. Back to Quisenberry, far corner. 12 on the shot clock. Quisenberry trying to shake Trey 2. Drives the right baseline, getting inside, bounce past Charlton. 5 to shoot. Crossing over, steps back, 6 feet, jumper is good, and Fordham with a 17-15 the lead with 7 minutes to go.
Love the Antrell Charlton mid-range jumper there, and exactly what Fordham needed to get out to a quick lead after the media timeout.
A jog bar on the right elbow, tries to find Trey 2, driving that right side, pulls back onto the right wing, swing past Silverstein left wing, underneath the basket is a jog bar, and he rolls this in for 2, and we're knotted up again at 17. 6:30 to go in the first half. Charlton walks it up for Fordham. High screen coming from Nowitzki. Driving that left lane, getting inside, kick out, straight on for Quisenberry. Off the side of the rim, tipped around, rebounded by Trey 2, and here come the Crimson. This one is thrown out of bounds. And a turnover for Harvard.
And I love the offensive possessions Fordham's having when the ball's in Antrell Charlton's hands early on. He's making an impact passing the ball and also with his shooting. He gets mid-range, but he's also finding his teammates and he's limiting his turnovers. No turnovers yet. That's been the weak point in his game this season, and he's doing a great job of limiting those in this one.
Around a curl comes Quisenberry on the top, pulls up from just inside the arc, and this one is off, rebounded by Ledlam, and here comes Harvard. Under 6 to go. We're knotted at 17 still. Sakota with a pass to Ledlam, defended by Khalid Moore. Trying to take Moore one-on-one. Now drives down the middle. A floater is in the lane is good. And Harvard back up 2.
And he's going to be the key. 30 points last time out. 29 the time before that. Just 4 points this afternoon for Ledlam.
Charlton working that right elbow. Pulls up in the middle of the paint again. Bounces off. Rebounded by the Crimson. Silverstein brings it up on the near side. Ledlam at the top of the circle. Silverstein on the right wing, now driving inside a jog bar and is fouled by Charlton on the way up. I believe they're going to call this one an act of shooting. Oh, it's going to be under the basket, so the Crimson will have it under the far side basket. Still 19-17, 5:14 to go in the first half.
And it's going to be the seventh and eighth free throws of the day for Harvard. Joe Barr is 2 for 2 at the line so far this game.
So new change to a shooting foul. So as Mike said earlier, Joe Barr is not a strong free throw shooter coming in. 43%. He's his first two so far. And second one is good.
And he's defying those numbers 3 for 3. But as a whole, this is a team that struggles at the free throw line, shooting 63%. That's 318th in the NCAA. So they get to the line, but they've at times struggled cashing both free throws in when they get there.
So Jogbar bounces both in 4 of 4. He really is defying expectations. So a 4-point lead for Harvard. 5:10 to go in the first half. Charlton will walk it up. Swing pass Rose on the right wing. Under the basket, Khalid Moore couldn't hang on. And Fordham turns this one over. That's their fifth.
There's a lot of time in this first half for a team to gain momentum heading into halftime. 5 minutes can mean a 10-12-point run, depending on how you play.
Ledlam at the top of the circle. Khalid Moore defending him. Kick pass, Silverstein near corner. Off the side of the rim, rebound, Simbila.
And great defensive job by Moore so far on Ledlam, keeping him in front and also forcing him to take that shot if he wants to score.
Rose sees a high screen by Simbila. Right wing three. A sidestep is good. Boyd and Fordham need that. 21-20 now with 4:30 to go in the first half. Fordham's starting to pick up their physicality. Trey 2 swing pass Silverstein right wing. Back to Trey 2 with the left wing defended by Rose. Crossing over, driving left. Tries to wiggle around everybody but can't. Silverstein on the left wing. Swing pass Sakota now. 10 to shoot on the shot clock. Quisenberry defending him. Long pass far corner. Silverstein with a loose handle. Players diving. 2 to shoot. And a shot clock violation. Harvard turns this one over. They're sixth.
And Coach Ergo loves that defensive possession. All over the ball. Relentless effort in defense. And that's what this team prides themselves on. They're an offensive team more so than they were last year, but the defense is still the heart of what they do best.
21-20 lead for Harvard, just under 4 to go. Quisenberry and Charlton play catch on the top half of the offense. Quisenberry right wing, pulls back at the right elbow, now trying to get back outside. 15 to shoot. Fordham zips the ball around the perimeter in the left corner for Charlton. Tries to take Sakota one-on-one. Getting inside the paint. Draws a double. Far corner. Khalid Moore. Well off the side of the backboard again. Rebounded by Harvard. 3:30 to go in the first half. Silverstein driving. Spinning in the middle of the paint. Dump pass for Ajogbar into the basket. And he's called for steps. 21-20 is the score. 3:25 to go in the first half. Harvard is up one on the Fordham Rams. Let's send it to a one-on-one scoreboard with Will Jing.
The one-on-one scoreboard.
Sunday football continues as the Jets are now up on the Bears 14-10. Denver is now down 10-3. Tom Brady's Bucks still trail the Browns 10-7. Baltimore is now up 6-0 on Jacksonville. Miami continues to beat down on the Texans, now up 17-0. The Titans now hold a 10-3 lead over Cincy, and the Falcons Commanders game is now knotted 10-10. Over in the other football, or as some call it, football, Alphonso Davies scored the first ever Canada goal in FIFA history against Croatia, but they fell short earlier today. Also earlier today, Costa Rica defeated Japan and Morocco defeated Belgium. Yesterday was a big day as well for FIFA as Argentina defeated Mexico 2-0, Poland beat Saudi Arabia, and France beat Denmark. Currently, Spain is playing Germany in a battle of two powerhouses. Over in the NBA, the Nets will start their game against the Blazers at 3, hoping to get back on track after a shaky 9-11 start. With WFUV Sports, I'm Will Jing.
Welcome back to our coverage of Fordham men's basketball on WFUV Sports. Alongside Mike Calamari, I'm Thomas Aiello. 21-20 is the score of Harvard up on Fordham, 3:25 to go in the first half. And Mike, if you like defense, you've come to the right game because this has been a really gritty defensive game. But if you like offense, you might want to walk out of the gym for this first half because you might get a headache just watching how bad both of these teams have been shooting.
I think the one hope is that it's hard to shoot worse than the teams have so far, under 30% from the field. But these are teams that have the ability to score. Darius Quisenberry, Khalid Moore, they are going to get things going. Khalid Moore yet to get on the board. He's 0-for-3 from the field. Darius Quisenberry has really kept this team in it with 8 points, 2-for-7 from the field, but both of his field goals have been behind the arc for threes, and he's hit 2 free throws. So get Khalid Moore going in the offense. I think things will get a lot better for Fordham. And Harvard, we mentioned it, it's Ledlam. Getting him involved. This is someone that's been your guy all season long. He can shoot off the dribble, and he's been amazing. 30 points versus Loyola Chicago. He's coming off of that season high. His two highest so far this season are 29 points and 30 points. He has 3 games over 20 points per game. For Harvard, he is the key. Get Chris Ledlam involved, and you're going to get your offense going.
So Fordham will inbound. Will Richardson walks it up. 3:24 to go in the first half. Richardson trying to pick the pace up. Quisenberry now bounce pass to Charlton. Right wing is Abdu Simbila. Fordham working that right side. High screen coming from Simbila. Harvard deleting the pick and roll, essentially. Far near corner, it's Charlton, 10 on the shot clock. He'll pull a three ball. Nothing there. Ball tipped around. Khalid Moore wrestling for it. Dives on it. Ball loose. Silverstein comes up with it. Far side now, Trey 2. Double team by Quisenberry and Richardson. A little bit of the trouble. Far corner for Ledlam. Now driving the left baseline. Tipped around. Ball still loose. People diving on the floor under the basket for Silverstein and couldn't hold on. And a turnover for Harvard.
I love the energy on the defensive side of things. A lot of hands. A lot of pressure on the ball handlers. And Fordham, their defense has really been the key in this game so far. It's not just Harvard missing shots. It's what Fordham's done defensively that stopped the Crimson from scoring.
Walking up the middle is Quisenberry. Now turns on the Jets down the right lane, and he'll go to the free throw line. Again, diving to the floor. One of his favorite things to do is Darius Quisenberry will go to the line for two.
And Quisenberry, such a good free throw shooter. So that's what adds so much to his game. He's able to get to the paint, but if he gets fouled, it's almost equivalent to a basket shooting, over 90% from the free throw line. He's 2-for-2 today, and having a player you can rely on like that at the charity stripe, really, really good for a team.
So his first free throw is good, so now Fordham ties it at 21. 2:30 to go in the first half. The amount of times that Quisenberry hits the floor, one could maybe question if he plays football for Fordham as his second one goes down. So Quisenberry, 4-4 on the day from the line. He's got 10, and Fordham back up one. Far wing is Silverstein, down the middle Okpara, driving inside, short off the rim. Moore and Simbila with a gang rebound. Charlton now on the left wing, trying to drive on Silverstein. High screen from Moore, works back to the middle of the floor. Khalid Moore on the left wing tries to drive on Silverstein on the left block into a post up with a pump fake. A little hook shot is good, and the lead for Fordham is now up to 3, 24-21 with a 2-minute drill. Trey 2 and Richardson going at it 94 feet. Far corner, Silverstein pulls a 3, and that one's good, and we're tied at 24. 1:45 to go in the first half. Charlton walks up for the Rams. Bounce pass Richardson, the left wing 3. Nothing there. O-board Simbila and puts it right back up and in. Abdu Simbila puts Fordham back up 2. 1:25 to go in the first half. Sakota brings up for Quisenberry. Near side and throws it away. Almost hit us. And a turnover again for Harvard.
Flew right over us and right over some of these fans who are courtside. And wow, what a back and forth there is. Fordham now with a 26-24 lead.
So as Mike said, Fordham is up 2. 1:20 to go in the first half. Tommy Amaker calls a timeout. And within reason, Mike, if you're Harvard especially, a team that's come in, they've been an efficient shooting team from all three levels. They're really quick. And we're kind of, like I said earlier, it's kind of like a speed walking pace, if you will, of this game so far. I mean, Fordham, they like to make it a track meet, but no one's really going at 100 miles an hour, but they're not really going at 0 miles an hour. It's hard to gauge, really, what sort of tempo both teams are trying to play.
Yeah, and I think Fordham's starting to get back into their game, shooting a lot better from the field, getting Khalid more involved, Darius Quisenberry. He's really found his offensive groove back that we alluded to at the top of the broadcast. Double-digit points to start, shooting well, efficient from the field. But if you're Harvard, got to get Christian Ledlam involved. I mentioned it. He's had two shots today. He's made both of them. Thankful for Silverstein, who stepped up with 10 points. But you have to get your best player involved if you want to come out to a lead before halftime.
Quisenberry walks it up. Minute 14 to go in the half. Near side wing Quisenberry back to Kyle Rose with a pump fake. Charlton around the screen. Far corner is Moore back to Charlton, a right wing. Three is good. Put three more on the board. Fordham's up 5:60 seconds to go in the first half. Rose playing Trey too closely, switched on to by Khalid Moore. Down the middle, down the left baseline is Okpara. Kick it back out, and another turnover here for Harvard, and this one will go back into Fordham's hands with 47 seconds to go.
Defense leading to offense, the tenacity of the Rams on the defensive end, it's creating momentum, it's leading to their offensive possessions. A great three by Charlton on the other end, and now they have the ball back after forcing the turnover.
So Fordham will have it beyond the half court mark. That was a very costly turnover given these circumstances, and Fordham will get into their half court set immediately. 45 seconds to go. The Rams up 5. Charlton at the top of the circle. High screen by Simbila. Crossing over. Pulls up. Free throw line. Jumper is in. Charlton with back-to-back scores. And it's a 31-24 lead. 30 seconds to go in the first half. Fordham now picking up full court. Quisenberry picking up Sakota at the top of the block F. Silverstein far side. 20 seconds to go. Trey 2 now, 15 seconds to go. Shot clock turned off. Defended by Kyler Rose on the near side. High screen by Ledlam. 10 seconds. Trey 2, free throw line. Jay, nothing there. Simbila the board, 3 seconds. And we have a whistle. This is going to be a timeout called here by Keith Ergo. So a fascinating timeout called by Fordham. 31-24, they're up.
Stay tuned for the 101 halftime report with Ryan Gregware and Will Jing. They'll recap the first half, talk all things Fordham basketball. They'll also be joined by Danny Scott, our New York Jets beat reporter, for an update live from MetLife Stadium.
Well, you heard Mike, 2:03 on the clock here in the first half. 31-24 is the score. The Fordham Rams are up on the Harvard Crimson. Mike, coming out of this timeout, put yourself in Keith Ergo's shoes. What are you drawing up out of this timeout?
I think Antrel Charlton's really been the hot hand, but you can't forget who your best player is, so if it's me, I try to find Darius Quisenberry, give him an opportunity to have a catch and shoot. But if not, Antrel Charlton's been playing great basketball. If you can give him an opportunity from mid-range or just with a chance to maybe have a little bit of an ISO with just over 2 seconds left, whatever you can get, that's what they'll do here. But they're going to have the ball from just out on the side. I'm still waiting to see where the ball placement will be.
It should be beyond half court, I think.
There, yeah, the referees are pointing. It's going to be underneath the basket on the other end. So Fordham's going to basically have to push it down the length of the court for a basket as they set up for this inbounds play. So I originally thought they would be able to at least advance the ball.
Well, where's Tim DeMorat when you need him for a long pass, right?
Tim DeMorat? When the inbounds play specialist?
Kyle Rose will take it on the near side just in front of the alumni. Throws it with his right hand. Simbila crashes into Ledlam, just flat out decks him. And that's how the first half ends. Fordham up 31-24 on the Harvard Crimson. But we're going to send it to the one-on-one halftime report with Ryan Gregware.
The one-on-one halftime report.
Welcome in to the one-on-one halftime report. Ryan Gregware here, going to be joined with Will Jing in a second. Fordham leads this one 31-24. We have so much to get into here in this first half, but as Mike just mentioned, we have a treat. We have Danny Scott here on the line, our Jets beat reporter. So before we get into everything in this Fordham game, we're going to talk about the Jets as they head towards halftime. Danny, you with us? Can you hear us?
Yeah. Hey, Ryan, how's it going?
I'm doing well. Thank you for joining us. So I believe right now Jets are up 14-10. Am I correct on that?
14-10, just a few seconds left before halftime. They're fourth down right now, but they're driving, looking to go up by at least a touchdown.
Awesome. And the story of this game is Mike White getting the start for Zach Wilson. Robert Saleh, head coach of the Jets, talked about he needs a reset. And in this one, Danny, you're at the game. You've seen the throws that White has made. Looking at the stat sheet, he looks like he's playing phenomenal. What have you seen from him thus far?
Well, yeah, he's playing great. He's a very accurate quarterback, you know, 15 for 19 so far through one half. Make that 16 for 20, actually, 235 yards, two touchdowns. The offense is just looks so much more comfortable than they have all year long, able to drive the ball down the field. A couple of great passes to Garrett Wilson leading to the two touchdowns. So he's coming away with two touchdowns in the first half, but the offense just looks a lot more competent with what he's not making these crazy mistakes. He's just finding the open receiver and not trying to do too much, which I think was a massive issue with Zach Wilson playing quarterback.
Yeah, Danny, hey, it's Will. I have a question as well. We've actually been able to check out a little bit of the game here in the studio on the TV. What do you think is the Jets' key to winning in the second half?
Just keep playing their game. They have one of the best defenses in the NFL, and just not turn over the ball. That was a big issue with Zach Wilson in there. It felt like every 5 minutes there was an interception or a fumble of some sort. But the defense has been phenomenal all year, so they just got to keep playing their style of football. It was kind of surprising to me that this Bears offense, with no Justin Fields, has been able to put 10 points up on them. But I expect them to come out of the second half, make some adjustments on the defensive side of the ball, and really kind of stifle this Bears offense without their starting quarterback.
Now, looking a bit more long-term, I was just having a conversation with our sports director, Bobby Chaffrini. Shout out to him. We talked about how this could potentially, if Mike White plays well, and it looks like all signs are pointing towards that, what this could mean long-term for Zach Wilson, the second overall pick just a year ago. Robert Saleh has said, you know, it doesn't necessarily mean his season is over with this benching. This was more of a reset. But could you see, Danny, a scenario where Mike White wins this football game versus the Bears? Does he keep this job? What are you seeing from the Jets potentially long-term at quarterback or even just this year?
Yeah, I'll have a much better answer for you post-game after I get in the locker room and hear Coach Saleh talk. But right now, it definitely looks like this team is in much better hands with Mike White at quarterback. It's a little similar situation to what the 49ers are going through with Jimmy Garoppolo. You know, Trey Lance looks like he has more upside, but to win right now, right in this current day and situation, for the Niners, it's Jimmy G. For the Jets, it may be Mike White. He's a guy that's going to be more of a game manager, just going to drive the ball down the field and get you points. He's not going to do anything crazy, but he's not going to hurt you in any way.
Yeah. Also, I'm wondering, the Jets haven't had a lot of running success in this game so far. Why do you think that is?
They haven't needed to. The quarterback play has been the best it's been all year. So when it was Zach Wilson, you know, they were kind of running the ball a lot more to take away from Zach Wilson making mistakes. But today, Mike White has been unbelievable, 16 for 20 already. So they don't really need to run the ball if the passing game is going to be where it's at.
Now, last question for you, Danny. Appreciate you joining us. It looks like the Jets kicked a field goal. So 17-10 the score. Looks like we're heading into halftime. So up seven here. We've talked about Garrett Wilson, those two big-time touchdowns for him. Is this going to be enough for this team? You know, you look at other guys to contribute. Is there somebody on that receiving core or perhaps in the run game that you mentioned that you see will have to step up in the second half if the Jets want to get to 7-4?
Yeah, Elijah Moore. He has been kind of out of the offense since Zach Wilson took over earlier in the year after Joe Flacco. But Elijah Moore looked good in the first three games of the year, and now he's got a massive 42-yard reception already in this one. I expect him to be a lot more involved in the offense without Zach Wilson at quarterback. So just hoping that he's going to be able to make some plays. And I do agree in some sense with Will that, you know, the ground game hasn't been able to get going, but it also hasn't needed to. So if they, especially with how bad it's raining right now, if they really want a chance to move on to 7-4 in this one, I do think they need to start moving the ball on the ground, getting Michael Carter more involved, as well as Ty Johnson.
Thanks, Danny. Real quick, Lena, last point here, predictions for this game.
For the Jets game or for
Yes,
the
for the Jets
game.
Yeah. I mean, I assume you're not watching the Fordham game right now to give a second half, you know, analysis here.
No, I think the Jets are going to come away with this one. I think they're a better team. I think they have better coaching. I think they have better players. So I'm going to go, you know, I think the Jets hang on to this one. I don't think this game scores very many more points, maybe like 17 to 24. The Jets pull this one out.
Danny, thank you so much for joining us. Enjoy the second half of the game, my friend.
Thanks, guys. Have a good one. Go Rams.
Yes, sir. As we thank Danny for joining us there, and Will, let's shift to this Fordham game. 31-24 at halftime, and Tom has brought this point up on the broadcast. Not what you expected in this game. You expected the points to be flying off the board, but especially that first 14 minutes or so, they really came at a premium. Both teams struggling from the floor. Fordham did pick it up a bit to kind of close that gap, go on a 7-0 run to end the half. So impressive stuff from there. Wondering, Will, what you saw in that first half.
I just think that they need to pick up the intensity and the speed a little bit. I think that'll help them score more points and expand this lead. And, I mean, defensively, obviously, it's a low-scoring game, so that means that, you know, both teams have been doing all right. Both teams are 5-1, so both teams are obviously, you know, pretty solid. But, yeah, I just think it's taking that whatever momentum they had from that 7-0 run at the end of the half and just extending into the second.
Now, looking at the box score here, Darius Quisenberry leading the way for Fordham, as he does all season, with 10 points. And then Antrell Charlton with 7. And he's a guy, the point guard for this team. There have been some turnover question marks this year, but you look at the box score. Just 5 turnovers for the Rams in the first half. Harvard has 10. So Fordham, something they don't typically do is win the turnover battle. And when they play at the pace that they want to, Will, that fast pace that you mentioned, that's paramount. You need to play at a good pace. You need to win the turnover battle when you want to do so. So to be doubling there, I think that's what I look at as the key stat. That's the reason Fordham's up 7 the first half in this one.
Yeah, I think it's also, as much as it is about, you know, speeding up the tempo, it's also about making sure you have control, you know, at that type of tempo. And I think when you have, you know, when you're playing at your play style and when you also have control over the turnover battle and, you know, you're making the other team make mistakes, I think that's absolutely key.
And Chris Ledlum for Harvard, a guy coming to this game, averaging 20 points a game, what Fordham typically likes to do on defense, they'll take your best guy away. They want to prove that the role players can beat you. It's been no surprise that we've seen that in this one. I mentioned him averaging 20-plus going into this game. He has just 4 points, but what I look at, just 2 shot attempts. So, yes, he's made both of those, but Fordham has done a great job, Will, at limiting his chance to let them beat them. They're not going to let that top guy really attack the Rams on the defensive side of the ball.
Yeah, I think when you this happens at every single level. When you take away a team's best player, you're just really putting the other team to the test. And it's all up to, you know, if the Fordham Rams can continue doing that, as you said, it's going to be up to the role players. And if they can perform, they might be able to keep this a close game. But if not, and Fordham continues to, you know, again, carry the momentum, control the turnover battle, do the little things like diving for the ball, as, you know, we heard Thomas talking about, I think that's going to bring the Fordham Rams a win.
And looking again at this box score, just dissecting the first half for Fordham, you know, this is a team, a lot of depth. And Coach Ergo has talked about kind of finding that rotation, seeing what guys work with what lineups. And it looked like we're really seeing some continuity starting to take shape with this team. We see all 5 scorers playing 14-plus minutes in this one. All of them have points, and nobody on the bench has points. So the typical starting 5, it looks like they've been getting it done in this one. I bring up Darius Quisenberry leading the way with 10 points. Antrell Charlton right behind him with 7. Then you have Kyle Rose and Abdou Sambilla with 6 apiece. Kyle Rose, 2 threes in this one. For Fordham on the offensive side of the ball, Will, we just have a few minutes here left on the halftime show to keep up with Harvard, a team we expect in the second half to come out with a lot more juice. What do you think they have to do to stay on top of this one and move to 5-1?
I think it's, on the defensive end, a lot about doing the same stuff. I think that that's gonna be enough. And as far as scoring goes, I'm also looking at the box score. 34% from the field is not exactly great. And, you know, Darius Quisenberry, who's arguably their best player, is 2-for-7. I just think that, you know, their three-point percentage is not bad, but if they can get their field goal percentage up, win the rebound battle, which it looks like they're losing by a little bit, I think those are going to be key things to turn around in the second half.
Yeah, I look at here just my last thought is Khalib Moore with just 2 points. That's somebody, he's been a second half player for the Rams. So not a surprise to see him just have 2 points, but we've seen him take over games, have 14 second point halves. That's the guy I look at because Darius Quisenberry, he's always going to get his Kyle Rose from three, good as anyone in the A-10, but Khalib Moore has that skill set that's so rare you see at this level coming from a power five. You really expect him to be a guy that can take it over in the second half, have, you know, a 5 minute run where it's him with the basketball, taking it up, defending, shot blocking, rebounding the whole nine yards, because that's what he does on the court. Such an impact player. So I think, Will, that's just about going to wrap up our halftime report. Fordham again leads this one 31-24. We're going to send it back to Tomasello and Mike Calamari, but first a quick promo.
Hey everybody, Sam Davis here. Check out WFUV Sports on Twitter, YouTube, and Facebook at WFUV Sports, and Instagram at WFUV_sports. There you can find all of our content from our beat reporters covering all the New York professional sports, as well as clips and full shows from One on One, New York's longest-running sports call-in show. For everything WFUV Sports, follow us on our socials.
Welcome back, everyone, to the historic Rose Hill Gymnasium alongside Mike Calamari. I'm Thomas Aiello. First half action well done. We're about to get the second half underway. Fordham up 31-24 on the Harvard Crimson. And Mike, it's been a very slow game offensively. Defensively, however, both teams are really making their money's worth on that side of the floor.
Yeah, and I think, you know, you look at some of the first half stats. For me, the one that stands out for Fordham is 5 first half turnovers. They're averaging 17 per game so far this season, and they've been able to force 10 turnovers against Harvard. They're doing a really good job on the defensive end, and those turnovers have led to points, and that's really the big thing here. 7 points off of turnovers for Fordham. That's the lead they have now, doing good defense, leaning it to offense, and the shots will start to fall. We saw that at the end of the game. They're now 5-13. From 3, 10 for 29 from the field is not what you want, but the threes are at least falling. Soon the rest of the shots will as well.
For Harvard, for their side of things, Sam Silverstein leads their team in scoring with 10 points. Justice Ajokbar with 8. Chris Ledlam, who was the guy we highlighted at the top of the broadcast, he's only got 4 points. And then only one other player has scored for Harvard, only 4 guys scoring. So if you're Tommy Amaker coming into the second half, that's got to change. The ball needs to start moving. Guys need to start shooting with a little bit more free will than they were in the first half.
Yeah, and Ledlam likes to play from the post. Most of his shots come from there. And he also likes to play an ISO. But Fordham has been doing a good job of making him do what he doesn't like to do, which is try to create from the three-point line or trying to play with a double team on him. And that's what the Rams are really doing, and they're going to have to adjust. Get your best player more chances. Ledlam averaging 13 shot attempts per game. He's at 20-plus points 3 times this year. He averages 8 field goal makes so far this year per game, and we're not seeing that type of play from him so far. He's only shot the ball twice, and he's made both of them, but he really just hasn't been able to get a good shot off since those first 2 makes. He's played 17 minutes, but you need to be able to get him good looks, and you need to be able to give him space to be able to work.
And for the Fordham, for the defensive side of things, if you like watching defense, someone like me, I'm actually enjoying myself watching them play defense. It's kind of interesting to watch, especially for both teams, but Abdu Simbila has 3 blocked shots today. That's more than the entire Harvard team. They only have 1. The paint defense is going to be imperative in this second half, Mike, because if you can't defend the paint, now we talked about Harvard shooting, but they're attacking the basket. The paint needs to be shut down completely.
And Harvard, they've got 10 first half points inside the paint. That's almost half of the points they've scored so far. And, you know, they're a team that's been solid from the three-point line this season, shooting over 30% on the year, but they don't take a lot of threes. Their game really is inside the paint. So Fordham, they know that. They've started to see it now in the first 20 minutes, and now it's a chance for them to adjust. But Thomas, I love looking at these stats from the first half. There have been 2 points scored from the bench on either team combined.
Oh, that's an interesting one.
The Crimson have scored 2 points on their bench. Fordham has no points from their bench. So it's all been the starters. So the first five you saw to start the game, those have been the impact five on the offensive end. So both teams, get more guys involved. If you're Harvard, get Ledlam involved. That's your number one priority. But if you're Fordham, you need to give Darius Quisenberry some help. You need to give Kyle Rose, Andrew Charlton some help. That could be Khalid Moore. It could be someone on the bench. That's what they need to figure out, at least offensively here in the second half.
Well, let's see who gives a helping hand for both of these teams. The Silverstein inbounds has opened up the second half. Harvard now going right to left. Left wing is Silverstein. Picks up his dribble, now finds Sakota at the top. Back to Silverstein, left wing. Driving down the right side. Dumps it off for a joke bar. Ball tipped around. Loose ball. Ledlam comes up with it. 11 to shoot. Silverstein a far corner three. Well short. Simbila with the board. 9 rebounds now for the big man. Quisenberry walks it up for Fordham. Now drives the right lane. Pulls back on the right wing. A pump fake and a kick to Rose at the top. High screen by Simbila. Crossing over back to Quisenberry. On the right wing, 9 to shoot on the shot clock. Inside, and stripped away, and this one will stay with Fordham. 7 on the shot clock with just about a minute played.
And just the basketball IQ of Darius Quisenberry. Goes to the basket, gets swatted out, doesn't go for it, lets it go out of bounds. Now you've got to play out of bounds on the inbounds play.
Lollipop to Quisenberry on the right wing. Charlton swing past Kyle Rose, far corner at 3. Off the back iron, Sakota with the board. Harvard now brings this one up. Down the middle of the floor comes Sakota. Far corner, Ledlam, defended by Moore. Sakota at the top, defended by Quisenberry. Just about a minute played, still 31-24 Fordham. Silverstein driving down the middle, getting inside, and this one rolls off the left side of the rim.
And how good has he been? 12 points in just first half and a little more of play. He's been making up for the rest of the offense of Harvard.
He's only had 2 in the last game. Minute and a half played here in the second half. Hand off Quisenberry near side wing. Kyle Rose at the top finds Khalid Moore, far corner with a pump fake. Now drives left baseline. Charlton swing pass, Quisenberry near corner, 6 on the shot clock. Drives the right baseline, pulls back. Gets in the right block, a crafty move. Offensive board off the front of the rim, rebounded by Ledlam.
2 great moves by Quisenberry. Just a little bit short on both those chances.
At the top is Nelson. 2 minutes played here in the second half. Silverstein just beyond the block F. Finding Ledlam on that right wing, defended by Quisenberry. They're playing him tightly. 7 on the shot clock.
And there's the double team. Great job defensively by Fordham.
Quisenberry comes up with it into the hands of Charlton. Fordham now probing. Charlton with a head fake, crossing over on a jog bar on that left lane. In that far corner now, 3.5 played. Underneath the basket for Simbila. Baby hook is good with the left hand. 33-26, approaching 3 minutes played in the second half. Far corner at Silverstein. Charlton giving him a ton of space to shoot. Ledlam now on that right wing. Double team coming. Loses it, but picked up by Sakota. Swing pass Silverstein. Now jab steps, driving and spinning inside the paint. On the right block, picked off, Simbila throws it to the backboard. Fordham in transition on the far sideline. Charlton bounce pass and physical play. Nelson and Moore get tangled up. This one will be against Harvard.
What a back and forth there by Fordham. They've come out of the half with the lead, but they've really done a great job of asserting themselves. Up 33-26, you know, it's been a good start to the second half for the Rams.
So Parra comes in, Chris Ledlam will sit. So far, only 4 points for him, 3 rebounds. Khalid Moore inbounds underneath there, Fordham basket. Left elbow, Quisenberry. Driving inside, high off the glass, no. O-board, Simbila under the basket, flying in. Muscling his way in, and he's going to get fouled, and he'll go to the line for 2.
And sometimes it's not about going up with the purpose of actually trying to score the basket. He was double-teamed. There were four arms over him, but he just sees that, and he goes up, and all he needs to do is just show that there was contact in an attempt to go up for the shot, and that's what sends him to the free throw line.
So 8 points and 11 rebounds for Simbila. His first free throw is in. Beyond Quisenberry, Mike, Abdu Simbila has been the star of the show today, looking for what would be his first career Fordham double-double.
9 points, 11 rebounds, perfect 3-for-3 from the field and at the line. I hope you did not jinx it.
Well, I know you said it, not me. Second one is good, so Simbila with 10 points and 11 boards. So Fordham now up 35-26. And a foul here against Quisenberry. So 3 minutes and 15 seconds played here in the second half.
And just Harvard has not been able to come out and really establish anything so far in the second half. Scoreless in the last 2 minutes and change. Only 2 points in the second half.
Silverstein on that left wing. Lob under the basket for Okpara. Counted and one. He's fouled by Simbila, and he'll go to the line for one more.
Okpara goes up and sends Simbila up with him, and it's just a pump fake. So he goes right into the contact, and it's a great play. Sends him to the line and also slows down the momentum a little bit. You get the and one. Now a chance for the third point.
Chisholm Okpara, the young man from the Bronxville, New York. And off the side of the rim, and Charlton comes away with this board. Fordham now up 35-28. High side screen by Simbila. The alley-oop. Simbila with the slam! Send it in, big fella! A bolt of electricity goes through the Rose Hill gym. 37-28. Silverstein answers with a three. No good. Rebound, Khalid Moore on the near side. Right wing now pushing is Moore. Double team coming. Kick, Kyle Rose. Near wing three. Money! Five points in the blink of an eye. 40-28 lead for Fordham. 16-10 in the second half. Wow, what a sequence of events, Mike.
And we're barely into this game here, at least in the second half. But wow, Fordham comes out with a bang to start the second half. And how about the alley-oop to Abdu Simbila? He throws it down, his 12th point of the game. And then Kyle Rose, he follows it up with a three-pointer. The energy. It's just so clear that Fordham wants this game. They go into halftime, they have a lead, it's not enough. Now jumps to a 12-point lead. They're on a 5-0 run in just the last 30 seconds. And just under the last 3 minutes, they're on a 9-2 run. Great job by Fordham.
It's almost as if a coffee bean was injected into the Fordham offense as the student half-court shot misses on the first attempt. But it's really been a game of really, really short spurts, Mike. Truncated 5-point, 3-point runs. That is really what has been the epitome of scoring in this game.
Yeah, and listen, the Crimson need to try to figure out what they can do offensively to try to compete with Fordham. They struggled at times defensively in this second half, but if you look at the first half, they were great defensively. That has not been the problem so far. The shots are going to fall, but they have to start falling for the Crimson. We mentioned it, but Chris Ledlam, he's got 4 points. He's 2-for-3 from the field. He averages 13 field goal attempts per game. Right now, just 3 field goal attempts. That is not something you want out of the best player, the best offensive player on your team. He is the star. Coach Ergo talked about it before the game. He thought Ledlam was one of the best players they were going to see all season, let alone in the non-conference, let alone in the past few weeks. All season, he thought he was one of the best players. You need him to start getting things going. If you want to cut down this 12-point lead, if you're Harvard, that's the key. We mentioned it at halftime, but they haven't been able to solve it yet.
So, Mike, looking ahead a little bit, so we know that we talked about what Coach Ergo said about Chris Ledlam. Is this Harvard team maybe a preview of what Fordham is going to see in the Atlantic 10? Like, could this be a Davidson type of team or a Rhode Island? Maybe even a Loyola Chicago. You want to take it a step further, a St. Louis. Could this be the closest thing that they see in the out-of-conference schedule, aside from Arkansas?
Well, Arkansas, I don't think, reflects as much Atlantic 10 team. You're talking about a team in the top 15, and at some point date in this season, start the season, they were ranked. But you think about a mid-level Atlantic 10 team, Harvard is that in many senses. They beat Loyola Chicago. That's the team that's entering your conference this season. They beat them by 6 points. They've beaten Siena. They've beaten Northeastern. They've beaten Elon. They've taken down a lot of good teams. 5-1. This is a team that would be mid-level in the Atlantic 10. And it's great to see Fordham being able to have such a convincing lead just 4 minutes in here into the second half.
Mike said 4 minutes in the half number two, 40-28 for Fordham. They're up. Silverstein swing pass. Okpara on the far corner. Back to Silverstein, a right wing three. Rolls off. Ball tipped around. Offensive board, Okpara, and he lays it in for two. Chisholm Okpara getting work done under the boards, and it's a 10-point lead for Fordham. Motion offense coming for Fordham. Kyle Rose on the right wing. Khalid Moore on the right block, working on Ledlam. Backing his way down, a hook shot rolls off. O-board tipped out by Simbila. Khalid Moore under the basket, a reverse. Too short, and Harvard comes away with it. Here comes Sakota. Nelson in transition, goes up with the left. This one's tipped around, but the board by Okpar under the basket. Nelson will shoot a far corner three, and that one goes in. And just like that, it's back to a single-digit lead for Fordham.
Blink of an eye, 5 points on the board after media stoppage, and a big 5 points for the Crimson.
Charlton drives the right lane. Pump faking under the basket. Quisenberry near corner, drives the right baseline. Trying to find someone, somehow weaving through. Finds Khalid Moore under the basket for a cut. Counted in the foul. Khalid Moore hits the deck. Has a chance for one more. It's a 42-33 lead for Fordham. Just over 5 minutes played here in the second half. Well, let's send it to a quick break. You're listening to Fordham Men's Basketball on WFUV Sports.
What's going on, guys? Bridge Gotham here, your New York Giants beat reporter for WFUV Sports. Be on the lookout for weekly reports and game recaps on WFUV's YouTube channel. We'll be covering the action all season long. Feel free to follow me on Twitter at BGBridge for updates throughout the games. For all things Big Blue, stay tuned all season long.
Hey everyone, this is Will Richardson, guard for your Fordham Rams. You can listen to us all season long over on 90.7 FM, WFUV Sports, and YouTube Live. WFUV Sports, the flagship station of Fordham Athletics.
Welcome back to the historic Rose Hill Gym, our coverage of Fordham men's basketball. Alongside Mike Calamari, I'm Thomas Aiello. 42-33 is the score. Fordham is up. 5 minutes and 10 seconds played here in the second half. Mike, it's been a spurty sort of game. Short runs have been the key to getting to a lead, and Fordham right now has a 9-point lead because of a 5-point spurt.
And that's basketball right there. You're going to have swings. You're going to have momentum shifts. It was going all Harvard right after that timeout. We took about just, 3 minutes, 50 seconds into the second half, and then what do you know? An and one by Khalid Moore, head to another media timeout. Now the momentum's in Fordham's favor, and those sways are going to happen, but when you have a strong 9-point lead that Fordham has, maybe 10 if Khalid Moore catches it in the free throw, you're able to move with those sways as long as you can continue to have good looks offensively and have good effort on the defensive side.
And for Harvard, Sam Silverstein's their high man with 12, and Chris Ludlam still only with 4, but going into the halftime, it was just Silverstein, Ajogbar, and Ledlam who only scored for Harvard. Now, three other Crimson have joined in on the scoring, but that was a real issue for Tommy Amaker at that halftime break. It's maybe starting to unweave itself just a tad.
Yeah, and I think Harvard's slowly going to work their way back into it. Ajogbar and Silverstein have stepped up in a huge way. They own 20 points combined of Harvard's 33. Only 13 points have come from players not named Ajogbar and Silverstein. That's going to have to change if they want to get back into this. They need to incorporate more of their team.
Khalid Moore will go to the line for one free throw. This one is up and good. So back to a 10-point cushion for the Rams. 5 minutes and 10 seconds played here in the second half. Will Richardson picking up the full 94. Nelson trying to get past him, now does for a moment, but picked up by Charlton. Lob pass, and this one is turned over by Harvard. But Khalid Moore will bring this one up with Will Richardson. 14:30 to go here in the second half. Bounce pass Charlton, far wing. Quisenberry straight on with a head fake. Now pulls a right wing three on the step back, and that one's down. A 13-point lead for the Rams, and a foul here immediately against Will Richardson. Third team foul here for Fordham in this half. 13-point lead, 14:19 to go in the game. Swing pass on the near side. This is Silverstein. Handing off to Trey Twos, checked in. Okpara drives down the middle. Kick pass, far corner. Silverstein at three. That one goes down, and Harvard chops it down to 10. 14 minutes to go in the second half. Will Richardson, bounce pass to the far side for Charlton. Long pass near corner, Will Richardson. Swing pass to Quisenberry on the right wing, defended by Nelson. Trying to drive right with a little pump fake. Nine on the shot clock, Khalid Moore sees it, tries to make his move. Euro stepping, loses it off of his foot, and the Crimson in transition. And we're gonna have a take foul here for them with an intelligent foul to stop the fast break. And this should be a side out.
And I think it's gonna go against Darius Quisenberry. It'll be his third foul. So it's going to be something to monitor. Just 13 minutes left here in the game, and don't want to get into that 4-5 foul territory. They will take out Darius Quisenberry to try to watch out for those fouls.
Opara straight on three off the inbound, off the back iron, tipped around. Nowitzki diving to the floor, and Ledlam comes up with the O board. Swing pass Silverstein, far corner. 13:20 to go in the game. 10-point lead still for Fordham. Okpara. Left wing three ball, back iron, a third chance for Nelson. And picked off by Kyle Rose, and here comes Fordham. Lobs it ahead for Khalid Moore, in transition rejected by Trey Two, and here comes Harvard. Near wing is Nelson, working that middle area. Kick pass Okpara, far corner. And it's gonna get called here. Stepped out of bounds and a turnover for the Crimson.
And you get to this point in the game where not everything's going to go your way. Had a great breakaway chance for Khalid Moore. He gets rejected. Then another turnover on the other end that goes against Harvard. Those things are going to happen. You have to be the team that gives the most energy. That's who's going to be the team that's going to be able to either cut it close or pull away in this one.
Far corner, Khalid Moore, double team coming. Loses the handle. Charlton almost saved it, but let it go out of bounds. So Fordham has it side out on the far end.
And credit Harvard. Amazing defense against Khalid Moore. They've done an amazing job against him. He's 2-for-8 from the field, 5 points. And he's someone that shoots great efficiency from the field coming into this one, 58% field goal percentage. And 2-for-8 now today, only 5 points.
Inbound to Charlton, left wing. High side elbow is Rose inside the Khalid Moore on the right block, working on Okpara, spinning around and twirling, and he's going to get called for the offensive foul as he got tangled up with Okpara, and Keith Ergo is in disbelief. His jaw is to the floor.
I'm trying to figure out what the call would be there.
Probably the wraparound. I don't think you can't do that. I know that, but I don't know if
that's something we saw Chuba Ohams was exceptional at last season, but they're trying to get Khalid Moore involved. Credit to Fordham. They understand they need one of their best offensive players to start getting things going, but the Crimson have answered back on the defensive end.
So still a 10-point lead for Fordham, 12:28 to go in the game. Trey Two on the far wing, defended by Will Richardson. Far corner, Opara pulls a three. Nothing there. Rebounded by Romadine, who's just checked in. Rose on the near side. Entry feed is rejected and taken by Silverstein. Trey Two pushing that middle area. Ledlam drives right on Dean. Kick pass, far corner, Okpara. Another three. He's taken four threes. He's hit none of them. And here come the Rams. Will Richardson walks it up. Drives down the right lane. Getting inside. Eats the contact. Rolls off. Rebound by Ledlam. Trey 2. Ledlam straight on with a pump fake and a foul here on the floor against Charlton.
So it's six fouls against Fordham. So that's going to send them into the bonus. So another thing to watch out for.
A 10-point lead for the Rams. 11:39 to go in the second half. Let's go to a one-on-one scoreboard with Will Jing.
The one-on-one scoreboard.
In the NFL, the Panthers-Broncos game has remained relatively uneventful with the Panthers up 10-3 still. Tampa has gained the lead over Cleveland 17-10. Baltimore is now down to the Jags 10-9. The Dolphins are laying the smackdown on the Texans 30-0, and the Jets are beating the Bears 17-10. Two games are tied at 10-10, the Bengals versus the Titans and the Falcons versus the Commanders. In less than an hour, the defending champion Golden State Warriors will play the Minnesota Timberwolves with only half a game back from the standings. The Pacers play the Clippers at 4, Miami plays Atlanta at 5, the red-hot Boston Celtics host the Washington Wizards. The Cavs head to Motor City to play the Pistons tonight. Memphis heads to the Garden to play the Knicks. The Sixers play the Magic. And we will get a Luka Giannis matchup tonight with the Mavs and the Bucks. And the World Cup, the Spain-Germany matchup is still scoreless after the first half. With WFUV Sports, I'm Will Jing.
It's 90.7 WFUV New York. Listener-supported public media from Fordham, the Jesuit University of New York. On air, online, and always commercial-free.
Welcome inside the historic Rose Hill Gym alongside Mike Calamari. I'm Thomas Aiello. 46-36 is the score, 11:40 to go in the second half. Fordham is up, and Mike, it's been a hacking fest here in these last few minutes. I mean, just fouls and turnovers have really been the commonality in these waning few moments in the past couple of minutes.
And both teams scoreless in the last 2 minutes and 20 seconds. It's been a series of missed shots, some fouls, some turnovers, but it's a gritty game at this point here with Fordham hanging on, 10-point lead, just over 10 minutes to play. But as anything we've seen in this game, that can shift in a moment's notice. Harvard's been able to put up 5-0 runs, 7-0 runs, same with Fordham, so something you have to watch out for if you're Fordham. The defensive intensity needs to stay, and you need to be able to continue to get good looks on the offensive end.
So for Harvard, Sam Silverstein leading the way with 15. Darius Quisenberry with 13 for Fordham. Abdu Simbila with 12 points and 11 rebounds. Both teams have gone scoreless in the last 230 plus. So we're going to have an inbound under the basket for the Crimson. Nelson will take this one. Finds Ledlam on the far corner. Now Nelson trying to drive down the middle. Gets inside on Nowitzki. Banker off the left side for two. It's now an 8-point lead. Just under 11:30 to go. Charlton hands off for Rose on the near side. Finds Will Richardson. Fordham playing three-man weave at the top half of the offense. Charlton backs down on the left block on Trey 2. Trying to find a double team to draw. Kicks it out. Will Richardson is straight on three. Nothing there. O-board, Rostik Nowitzki. Kyle Rose on the left wing steps back for three. Nothing there. And rebound by Okpara. Nelson near sideline pushing on Will Richardson. Trey 2 on the left wing now. Still an 8-point lead. Under 11 minutes to go. Trey 2 left wing. 10 on the shot clock. Ledlam steps back. A straight on three ball. Off the side. Rebounded by Charlton. Charlton on that far left wing. Kicks it to Kyle Rose. Nearly loses the handle. Switched on to by Trey 2. 10-12 to go, still an 8-point lead. Rose driving the left side. Bounce pass underneath the basket for Nowitzki.
What a no-look pass there by Rose. A wide-open Nowitzki underneath the basket.
Back to a 10-point lead with 10 minutes to go in the game. Far side, Silverstein. Harvard opens up the motion. Okpara down the right lane and pushes Nowitzki out of the way for two. Back to an 8-point lead. Harvard not going away quietly. Charlton walks it up for Fordham. Draws a double on the left wing. Crosses over Silverstein, and he's going to get called for the grab.
And that's going to check in Simbila, Moore, and Quisenberry. So Fordham looks like they're going to stick with the three best players they've been having so far in this one to end it. And we'll see if Charlton sticks out for the rest of the last 9 minutes and 30 seconds. But trying to get that best five they can with at least Rose sitting out on the bench just to start with Richardson in. But they're going for their best five for the home stretch now as we are under 10 minutes.
So 9:35 to go. Fordham is up 48-40 against Harvard. As we said, Tommy Amaker-led teams incredibly competitive. Lob pass Charlton on the left elbow. Around the screen comes Quisenberry, a far corner three. That one is good for Darius Quisenberry. 11-point lead now for the Rams. Just under 9:30 to go. Silverstein at the block F. Now moves to the left wing. Entry pass to the block. Back inside. And the hook shot turnaround, no good. But Sakota right there for the finish. As a joke bar misses the hook shot. 9 minutes to go. 51-42 Fordham. Will Richardson. Charlton, right wing. Fordham trying to move that ball around. Under 9 to go now. 15 on the shot clock. Quisenberry going to try and take Nelson one-on-one. High screen coming from Simbila. 5 on the shot clock. Quisenberry falls down. Charlton sees the clock. A sidestep jumper, no good. Rebounded by Chris Ledlam. And here come the Crimson looking to push. Nelson at the top, defended by Quisenberry with a handout. Down the middle goes Ledlam, lays it up and in, counted and the foul.
And that's what Harvard was looking for, getting Ledlam downhill. They find him moving to the basket, gets the bucket to go on the nice floater just in front of the hoop and also goes to the free throw line. And that's the type of bucket that can get your best player going. It just takes one. And then if he starts to feel a rhythm out there, then Harvard can get back into this game.
So Ledlam will go to the line. He's only got 6 today. 7 rebounds, however. As this free throw is good. So Harvard trims it down to a 6-point lead. 8:23 to go in the game.
And that Crimson bench making some noise now. They're one of... get this momentum back as much as they can.
Will Richardson, high side. Simbila at the top of the circle. Hand off to Quisenberry, left wing. Sees the lane. Jow drives the right side. Bounce pass. Khalid Moore, far corner. Short. Ball tipped around. Simbila fighting for it with the Jogbar, and Okpara comes away with it. Sakota now on the near side, defended by Khalid Moore. High right post. Okpara. Ledlam will pull a right wing three. Off the backside, loose ball foul. This one's going against Harvard.
And Ledlam, someone who could hit the three over 38% this season from there, but that's not exactly what he looks to take, and you're going to take that shot if you're the Rams.
So a 6-point lead for Fordham, 7:49 to go in the second half. Let's send it to a quick break. You're listening to Fordham Men's Basketball on WFUV Sports.
Hi, I'm Michael Calamari, reminding you to tune into New York's longest-running sports call-in show, One-on-One. Catch all the breaking sports news, hot takes, inside scoops from our beat reporters, and interviews with people around the world of sports. One-on-One airs every Saturday from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. on YouTube Live, and once again at night from 11 p.m. to 2 a.m. on 90.7 FM. Want more One-on-One? Catch our Wednesday edition of the show, One-on-One Nightly, from 8:30 p.m. to 10 p.m. on Twitter and YouTube Live. Join the conversation and tune in to One-on-One, New York's longest-running sports call-in show.
Welcome back to the Rose Hill Gymnasium alongside Mike Calamari. I'm Tom Aiello. 51-45 is the score. The Fordham Rams up on the Harvard Crimson. It's been a really slow affair today in terms of pace. Fordham is scoreless in the last minute and 40 seconds. Harvard right now is on a 5-0 run. And if you're Fordham, you've got to start putting the foot on the neck of the tiger now if you're Fordham.
Yeah, and I think they're getting things going slowly. They've got their starters back into the game. They still are holding on to a 6-point lead, but Harvard has been in this game all along, but now they've made it a real competition as it's only a 2-possession game, under 8 minutes to go, and that lead can get away in seconds if Harvard's able to convert on the offensive end. They could get out to their own lead if they handle themselves well. So it's really anyone's game right now. You can almost forget the lead exists because Harvard can get back in it within a few baskets. Fordham has to keep the energy, and they have to claw their way back and get into that double-digit lead that's a lot more comfortable.
Harvard has trailed for the most part of today, but they've remained in striking distance with a 6-point deficit. Fordham's lead was 12 at one point. And Fordham will have this one out of the timeout. Charlton walks it up for the Rams. Trying to get something going. Bounce pass left elbow. Moore cutting under the basket is Kyle Rose. And that ends the drought as Fordham goes back up 8. Kyle Rose defending Trey Two far wing. Trey Two drives that left lane. Gets inside, met by 3 Rams. Ball tipped around. Nearly an offensive interference. And Charlton comes up with the loose ball. Fordham trying to push. Quisenberry ahead on the far sideline. Makes his move. Down the middle he goes. Pump fake on the right block. Kicked out. Khalid Moore at the top. 7 minutes to go in the second half. Khalid Moore driving the right lane. Swatted out of bounds by Ledlam. And a jogue bar, the combination. Fordham will have this underneath the basket, still with an 8-point lead. Khalid Moore will inbound under the basket. Lob pass for Charlton, right elbow. Spinning, driving, pump faking, throws up a layup, nothing there. Ball tipped around. Khalid Moore with the O board, and he's fouled under the basket. Now this should be 2 free throws coming Fordham's way.
And just creating opportunities for yourselves on the offensive glass. 6 offensive rebounds on the day for Fordham. They've also forced 14 turnovers. 7 offensive rebounds. The stat was loading in. 21 times they've gotten second opportunities, whether that's forcing a turnover or getting the offensive rebound.
So Khalid Moore's first free throw is good. So a 9-point lead for Fordham. 6:52 to go in the second half.
And usually see more scoring out of Khalid Moore, but the ability to grab 5 boards, 4 assists, and still have an impact is really what he's about.
Ledlam comes away with the board, nearly stepped out of bounds. Trey 2 and Ledlam decks Kyle Rose. There's a par in the far corner. Intercepted by Khalid Moore. Fordham on the attack. 2-on-1. Khalid Moore drives through off the front of the rim. Rebound by Trey 2. Harvard looking to push. Charlton tries to pick him. Okpara inside and lays it in transition.
And Coach Ergo, he's saying slow down to his team. Khalid Moore tries to take that in transition. He misses. And then because the ball is moving so quickly, Harvard's able to capitalize and move it the other way for a basket. Slow it down here. You have a lead and just try to find a good basket.
Left wing for 3. Charlton off the back iron. Rebound by Trey 2. And here comes Harvard. Puts Nowitzki on his backside. Lays it in with the right hand in transition.
And I'm not sure I love the deep 3 there early in the shot clock by Charlton. Long rebound. Harvard able to move a transition with the guard rebound. And that's how they get the bucket the other way. And the Crimson, they are fighting in this one.
Still a 5-point lead. 5:45 to go. Nowitzki at the top of the circle. Handoff for Quisenberry on the left wing. Defended by Silverstein. Trying to drive inside with a pump fake. Intercepted by Ledlam, trying to get it to Khalid Moore. Both teams are slowing the pace down here. Trey 2 brings it up on the left side. And the probes to the right, crossing over on Charlton. Kick pass, right wing, Okpara hits a 3. Chisholm O'Para cuts the lead down to two with 5:13 to go.
And he's shooting just over 20% from three this year, but he hits the one that counts, and now Harvard just a possession away.
Charlton left wing, Quisenberry at the top. 5 minutes to go in the game. Chance of defense from the Harvard fans. Quisenberry with a pump fake, short off the front of the rim. Rebounded here by Trey Two.
And the momentum is all in Crimson's favor. A basket here would tie up the game.
Trey Two, far wing, Silverstein bounces off the front. Charlton with the board. Inside right block Nowitzki, and he is tackled by Trey Two, but does not fall down. So Fordham will go to the free throw line. Both teams are in the penalty. 4.5 to go in the game with a 2-point lead.
And Thomas, if Harvard does convert on that 3-point attempt by Silverstein, that would be their first lead since 2 minutes and 31 seconds left in the first half. So it's been a long time coming for this Crimson team, but they have fought. They have been down double digits. They have gone back to 6, back to double digits. But slowly they have gotten back into this lead, a 7-0 run over the past 2 minutes.
Rostik Nowitzki will go to the free throw line. His first is good. He has the only 3 bench points today for Fordham. And Mike, here's an interesting concept. We could see Keith Ergo maybe turn this back to last year's Fordham team where they're playing a really, really slow pace to end this game, maybe to minimize points. As the second free throw is good, so Nowitzki cashes in.
And I want to slow down the pace, obviously, but it's still a 4-point lead, and I want the best shot possible. If that means pushing it, that means pushing it. If that means slowing it down, that means slowing it down.
Kyle Rose called in for the reach, and Nelson stares him down.
And Coach Ergo, not sure if he loved the decision there by Kyle Rose going for it, sending Harvard to the line now. But this Fordham defense playing tough. And it's going to be one of those games, Thomas, where it's going to come down to maybe that last shot, or maybe we're going to see a lot of fouls to end the game, sending the opponent to the line, making them hit a free throw. This is the type of basketball we haven't seen in a while at the Rose Hill Gym, and it's going to be exciting.
Off the rim, Cimbilo with the board, the missed free throw, so Nelson misses a critical one. Still a 4-point lead with 4:20 to go. Charlton accelerates past the timeline. Bounce pass Kyle Rose, right wing. Quisenberry at the top, high screen by Cimbilo. Rejected at the three by Ledlam. Quisenberry gets it, no backcourt. This is a piece by Ledlam. 8 to shoot on the shot clock. Charlton now left wing, crossing over. Free throw line jumper, rolls off. Rebound by Ledlam under the basket. Under 4 to go, still a 4-point lead for the Rams. Trey Two. Back and forth goes Okpara and Ledlam. Underneath the basket, Silverstein off the back door. Back to Okpara. Tipped out by Cimbilo with a huge block. Khalid Moore trying to get it, diving to the floor. Charlton now with another reach and foul.
So that's going to send the Crimson to the line. So after the quick break, it's going to be Harvard with a chance to cut it to a basket once again.
56-52 is the score. Fordham still up 4. 3:38 to go in the game. We'll send it to a quick one-on-one scoreboard with Will Jing.
The one-on-one scoreboard.
In football, Carolina has extended its lead over the Broncos to 17-3. The Dolphins are continuing to hold the Texans scoreless as they're winning 30-0. The Jets have also extended their lead to 24-10. And the Commanders are now up 16-13 on the Falcons at the half. In about an hour, more games will be starting as the Chargers play the Cardinals, the Raiders play the Seahawks, the Rams play the Chiefs in a battle of 2 recent Super Bowl champions, the Saints play the 49ers in an NFC matchup, and the struggling Packers play the 9-1 Eagles at 8:20 tonight. In the NBA, Brooklyn's game against the Portland Trailblazers is getting underway with the Nets at full strength with KD, Kyrie, and Ben Simmons. The Blazers, though, will be without their star point guard Damian Lillard. In other news, Lakers star LeBron James is only 1,016 points away from Kareem Abdul-Jabbar on the all-time scoring list as he continues his chase. In the World Cup game, the Spain-Germany matchup is now in the second half and still 0-0. With WFUV Sports, I'm Will Jing.
Thank you. Welcome back to the historic Rose Hill Gym alongside Mike Calamari. I'm Thomas Aiello. 4-point lead for the Rams against Harvard. 3:38 to go in the game. It has been a tight one here in the final stretch, Mike, but this is where the game's going to be won pretty much.
Yeah, and I was going back through the games Fordham has played this year. This would be probably the first time Fordham's won by single digits all year. You go through their schedule, 88-74 win versus Dartmouth, 79-61 win versus UNH, 79-65 win versus the University of Illinois Chicago. Then the past two games, 67-53 win over Holy Cross, and the closest of all of those, 71-60 win over Stonehill. And now they're looking at a 4-point lead, and it could get to double digits, but no matter what, it's never been this close with under 4 minutes to play. And this is what Fordham's been looking for. You want to feel this. You want to feel the pressure. You want to know what it's like to play in close games. You didn't really have that in your loss against University of Arkansas. You went down double digits after the first half. This is the first close game. Every possession matters. There might be a last-second game-winner attempt by either team. That's when you learn the most about your team, and that's where you gain the experience, and that's where you gain the chemistry. This is great for Fordham, but it's also a great opportunity to pick up another win with a 4-point lead.
So Harvard will get this one out of the timeout at the free throw lines. Edon Trey 2 will go to the stripe. The young man from Brooklyn, New York. So he's going to get two here. Both teams are in the penalty, so that's key. In the final stretch, 3 minutes and 38 seconds. As Trey 2's first free throw rolls in. So now a 3-point lead, 56-53 for Fordham. You hear the rumblings in the stands. The second free throw is good, so now a 2-point lead for Fordham. Final 3:38 in the game. Quisenberry walks this up for the Rams. High screen from Simbila. Pulls back. Khalid Moore at the top. Now drives down the middle. Bounce past Simbila. Met at the rim by three Crimson. And they're going to try and push Ledlam down the middle.
He's
going to get called for steps. What a costly turnover.
I had to stop myself short because I was trying to be a referee there and say Ledlam walked as soon as he caught the ball. And, wow, what a moment that would have been for Harvard, though. They had the numbers in transition. Just a costly mistake there.
Fordham opens the motion offense. Kyle Rose at the top. Left wing Khalid Moore. Drives the left baseline on Trey 2, and an offensive foul will go against Khalid Moore. That one looked really close, Mike.
But what a defensive play there by Harvard. They know they got to get in front of Khalid Moore. They do a great job there, and on the instant replay, it's a clear shove there by Khalid Moore. There's no contest made by either Moore or Coach Ergo. And that's just a great job defensively. You make the mistake on one end, you make up for it on the other, and now another chance for Harvard to try to tie this game up.
So Sam Silverstein, who's been the main catalyst today, brings it up. Trey 2 at the top of the block. F. Quisenberry playing him very close. 2:45 to go in the game. Fordham still up 2. Long pass, opposite wing. Okpara a 3 off the back of the rim. Ball's loose. Charlton comes away with it. Kyle Rose on the near side. Defended by Silverstein. Charlton driving down the middle. Kick pass, Quisenberry at the top. And the kick ball violation. This one's against Harvard, so we'll stay with Fordham.
And as much as Harvard's done the necessary things to be a bucket away from tying this game up, they haven't found that yet. They've had good chances, but they just haven't gotten the shot for fall. Fordham needs to try their best to get a good chance here, and you got to get the ball in hands of Antrell Charlton and Darius Quisenberry off the inbound to get a good look.
Lob pass for Charlton at the right elbow. Around the screen comes Quisenberry. Now makes his move down the right lane. Fading from 6. Bouncing. O-board Simbila. That's a huge rebound for the big man. Working in the paint. A left hook is good for Abdu Simbila. He pushes it out to a 4-point lead. So Fordham with some breathing room with 2 minutes to go. Chance of defense in the Rose Hill gym. Silverstein left wing driving on Simbilan, floats it in and quiets the crowd. Pendulum going back and forth here in Rose Hill. Both teams trading punches with a minute 50 to go in the game, Mike. It's a two-point lead, but this has been an entertaining end here.
It's been a great end, and it's exactly really, like I mentioned, both teams need to have this experience before conference play, and for Fordham, they're in a great position. Up 2 points, they'll have a chance really to control the game, but that can't mean you have bad plays on the offensive end, turn over the ball. You have to be able to win the rebound battle in the final few minutes, win the offensive board, win the defensive board. These are things Fordham is doing. If you're Crimson, you got to try your best here to tie it up, obviously. You got to play hard defense. You want to force that turnover. You're a team that's forced turnovers throughout the year. You're scoring 20% of your points this season off of turnovers, 15.5 a game. So that's a great spot for Harvard to start. Force a turnover and then get the basket on the other end.
So minute 51. Fordham is up two, and they're going to have the ball in the inbound. This second half has certainly made up for the lackluster first half.
And it's turned into a bit of an offensive game in the second half, a lot more fireworks than we saw in the first.
Charlton brings it up cross half court. Minute 45, bounce pass Khalid Moore, left elbow extended. Makes his move down the right lane with a pump fake, gets inside, lays it in for two. It's a curdling gut affair, but Fordham is somehow making things happen with a minute and a half to go in the game.
And the Fordham bench standing as they look on the other end.
Okpara far corner, driving the right baseline, down the middle, Silverstein, ball is loose. Charlton comes away with it. We've seen this movie before a lot last year, Mike. Fordham playing slow at the end with a 4-point lead. 65 seconds to go in the game. Charlton on the left wing, bounce pass Khalid Moore. Drives right again, stops, goes again. Inside, gets in for two. 6-point lead, 50 seconds to play. Silverstein left side, driving on the left block, now trying to find something, throws it up, rebound Simbila. And the Crimson hack the big man, and he's going to the line.
Two big free throws here. You have to lock back in if you're the Rams. 41 seconds of college basketball. The ability to foul, and especially with the way both teams shoot at the line, just under 75% is Fordham. So these free throws are no gimmies. And Bila 4-for-4 on the day from the charity stripe. He's a chance to get up to that 16, 17 point mark on the day. He's already at a career high in points. So this is two big free throws, Thomas.
This is by far the best game he's played of his collegiate career. His two free throws, the first one goes down. That one's huge.
And it's not just Simbila. This team as a whole is a lot better shooting the free throw than they were last year. 71.8% at the free throw line compared to 67.9% last season.
As the second free throw is good. So Abdu Simbila, 6 of 6 for the line today. 64-56, 37 seconds to go. Harvard up. Nelson driving the left lane. Backdoor cut, stripped away, and Quisenberry comes up with it. And Fordham's going to slow this one down. Quisenberry gets over the half-court mark. Three Crimson coming. Khalid Moore driving. Kick pass Rose on the left wing, and he's fouled by Silverstein. Charlton bringing his hands up in the air.
We haven't heard much from the fans throughout this game, but now they're really starting to get into it. A couple big plays go the Rams' way. Gets the crowd into it. Antrel Charlton raising his arms in the air, motioning the crowd. Get louder.
Kyle Rose's first free throw is down. 9-point lead for Fordham. 21 seconds left in this game.
And I mentioned single digit. They haven't had a single digit win. It still might not be the case. And a free throw here by Kyle Rose made a 10-point lead.
Well, this one is good. Now a 10-point pillow for the Rams. Harvard's got to hurry here. Trey 2 near side, bringing it up for Harvard. Gets it into the paint, and an easy 2 for the Crimson. A timeout by Tommy Amaker.
And great job by Trey 2, taking it to the lane there, getting to the basket, and still a game, and still some time to play here for Fordham.
Well, as it stands right now, if Fordham holds this lead, this will be the first time since 2012, and the first time in 4 of their last 5 tries that the Rams have beaten Harvard at home, mind you. It's been a while since they've taken down the Crimson. The last time they beat them, they were a ranked team in the country. That was the peak of their powers in that 2010s decade when 3 straight NCAA tournament appearances for Tommy Amaker's team. And this Harvard team has been no slouch, Mike. They've been competitive. They haven't shot the ball too well today, but they've gotten to the line. They've given Fordham all that they can handle. But Fordham's thrown everything right back at them, and they've got themselves a nice little 8-point lead.
And this is really the big time for Fordham. They've done a great job taking care of the ball all game long. 10 turnovers. They average 17 a game, so that's 7 less turnovers than their every game average. And take care of the ball now, though. This is where it really matters most. The turnover here on an inbounds play underneath the basket is the difference between just dribbling the ball out potentially or heading to the free throw for 2 free throws to ice the game, or maybe turning over to the Crimson and giving them an opportunity to cut this to 2 possessions.
So an 8-point lead for Fordham, 15 seconds to go. He's going to have a football formation. Kyle Rose under center with 2 receivers each to his right and to his left. Inbounds it to Quisenberry on the far corner, and he's fouled.
It's an interesting play. It's like they're running routes. Is
a little drag route this way, a little flat route that way.
So everyone started at the baseline, and then Kyle Rose finds Darius Quisenberry on a slant route to send him to the free throw line.
So a gain of about 4 yards, so Fordham will have 2 free throws. Essentially, if Quisenberry hits both of these, the game will be over. First one is down, so a 93% shooter hits his first free throw. It's 5 of 5 so far, 9-point lead for Fordham, 13.7 to play. He gets set for his second free throw here on Frank McLaughlin Day, and this one is down, so a 10-point cushion for Fordham. Harvard still has to go the length of the court. Trey 2 picks it up far side, behind the back, down the middle, gets past everybody, dunks it down. Wow, what a play by Edon Trey 2 with a 2-hand flush, 8.9 to go. Lob pass for Khalid Moore, gets across the timeline on the far side. 3 seconds, 2 seconds, and for the first time since 2012, the Fordham Rams take down the Harvard Crimson 68-60. Their first single-digit win on the season. Mike, you called it. What a gutsy performance, though, by this Fordham team. But what a competitive performance as well by the Harvard side.
Yeah, this is one of the first games, and I know it's an 8-point win, but it felt so much closer throughout the game the entire way. And a huge, gritty win for Fordham, and it really showed their ability to fight, do their best to hold on to that lead, and then come away with the victory, now moving to 6-1 in the season.
And for Harvard, they go to 5-2, but you can't look past the effort they had today. I mean, Sam Silverstein was lighting it up, 17 points. Chisholm Okpara with 11, and Edon Trey 2 with 10. I mean, just a really good performance. And Chris Ledlam, their goal today was to hold them to 7 points, to hold them to under double-digit scoring. He had 7 points today. As we are going to be joined momentarily by Fordham assistant coach Ronald Ramon, throwing on the headset here.
Coach, how's it going?
Coach, welcome back to the Post Game Report. Your opening thoughts on tonight's game.
First of all, I think Harvard is a great team. They play hard. We knew it was going to be a hard-fought game. But I think our guards play hard, too. You know, they came out to play. They were motivated. We just stayed within ourselves. Right? We knew we had a game plan. We came out and executed. Offensively, we moved the ball well, found guys. We stayed composed. We got into the paint, found guys on the perimeter. So I think we played a great game.
Abdul Sabila, 16 points. That's a career high. 15 total rebounds as well. Gets the double-double. He also went a perfect 6-for-6 at the free throw line. Just what did he do today?
Man, I feel so happy for Abdul. He works hard. He comes in every day. He do everything that we ask him to do. And today was one of those games that we were able to find him. But defensively, I think he was huge for us. The way we played defense tonight, having a guy at the rim, being able to contest and change their shots, I think he did that amazing. So, you know, he just keep getting better. You know, I think every game he keeps getting better. He keeps buying in to everything we're doing. So I'm happy for Abdul.
Coach, this was by far your closest game you guys have been in. And we were saying this is the closest thing maybe to an Atlantic 10 type of team, but Tommy Amaker comes in with a really good reputation. Did you expect anything different from him today coming into the gym?
Not at all. We knew it was going to be a hard-fought game. A smart team, composed, they don't get rattled, right? They're doing a great job, especially their guards, trying to find guys, stay within the offense. Letlum is having a great year for them, just had 30 points out of their 61 points against Loyola, so we knew it was going to be a battle. So we came out and just try to execute, try to get better every possession and trying to execute our game plan.
You mentioned Chris Letlum there. He was coming off that 30-point game against Loyola Chicago. He played 36 minutes tonight, but only shot 6 times. What did you guys do defensively at him? And what did you guys do defensively as a team against Harvard?
I think we just try to take him away from the offense, right? Trying to get him away from his spots where we knew he was going to catch the ball, try to score. And try to just, if you interrupt their offense, it's hard to play, right? So that's one of the things that we try to do today. But we try to rebound the ball. And then offensively, like I said, our guys are doing a great job of playing unselfishness basketball. They just literally passing the ball well.
Coach, we appreciate the time. Congratulations on the win.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Coach.
Yep. Fordham assistant coach Ronald Ramon. A job well done today for the Fordham Rams, Mike. It wasn't easy, as Coach said. It was going to be a battle. This Harvard team, they're always very, very good, very, very competitive, always at the top of the Ivy League, and they showed us why today.
Yeah, a great game, an energetic game, a lot of moments that you're going to look back on and say, wow, what a play there, and what a chance by Harvard there, and what a way for the Rams to close it out. And a great game, and probably the best one we've seen, I would say, at the Rose Hill Gym this season. And now Fordham gears up to go to New Orleans, and that should be a great time, too.
Their next game against Tulane in the American Athletic Conference, a team also projected to go to the NCAA tournament. But that is just about going to do it from the Rose Hill Gym. Alongside Mike Calamari, this is Thomas Aiello saying so long. And we'll send it back to the Rose Hill Studios for the one-on-one post-game report.
The one-on-one post-game report.
Welcome into the one-on-one post-game report. Ryan Gregware here, joined with Will Jing. Fordham basketball wins this one 68-60, a super impressive win versus one of the tougher non-conference opponents that Fordham will have this year. Really impressive. The star in this one, Abdul Sabila, his true breakout game as a Ram. 16 points, 15 rebounds, 5 blocks, absolutely exploded after halftime as Fordham, Will, it got close a bit, but they did a great job of maintaining this lead despite it getting to a one-possession game. They were full force in the second half.
Yeah, I think Sabila made a big difference. You know, going 5-for-6, 15 rebounds, 3 offensive boards, and 5 blocks. I think that's huge, being the second leading scorer on the team next to Darius Quisenberry. I didn't expect that. And
no.
I think that to have such a big impact from one guy coming out of the half, and you know, they kept down the turnovers I believe only 5 in the second half as well, just like the first half. So I think those things really helped them in the win.
Now there's a few things you can look at, but we have to highlight Abdul Sabila because he's been a guy. He has all the physical traits, and the coaching staff last year and continuing to this year, they raved about him. They called him a physical freak. He hurts guys in practice. But we hadn't seen it translate to the game like this. And this is the true breakout game. You know, he's had some good games here and there, but his first career double-double, he had five blocks as well. So the interior force that he brings, that presence, we've heard so much about it, Will. Obviously, coming over from Penn State, he's an ergo guy. To see him really blossom into this game, solidify that starting five spot in the absence of Chuba Oham, who this team definitely misses. They miss his 20-plus double-doubles from last year. To have Abdu Sambila step up in this game, if this is a sign of things to come for Fordham, this is massive going forward.
Yeah, I think that this is big for the future, especially because, you know, Quisenberry's not going to be around too much longer. So it's almost like they need that one guy to be the face of the team and really step up to be like the future of the team. And I think Sambila is showing that he can be that guy. And I think also, I mean, I just noticed this, I think the free throw battle was also key in the game, because Fordham only missed one free throw out of 19, and Harvard got sent to the line way less often and missed more.
It's a great point, because you look at that, Fordham, they win the free throw battle by 9, they win the game by 8. So that's what it comes down to sometimes, the little things. And how about the Fordham defense in this one, holding Harvard to 39% from the field, but more importantly, 5 for 23. From three-point range, that's just 22%. The guy that, you know, Mike and Thomas have talked about, Ledlam for Harvard, comes to this game averaging over 20 points per game. He had 4 at halftime, as we talked about, just 7 total points in this one. Fordham did a great job, Will, of taking away Harvard's best player.
Yeah, to have only one player score more than 11 points, that's as close as you're going to get to guaranteeing a win. And, I mean, I'm looking at the box score. There's a lot of little things that happen. You know, like you said, just keeping the three-point percentage for Harvard down. Had Harvard made, what, 3 of those threes, we would be having a different story right now. So I just think the fact that, you know, just doing every single little thing they can, you know, as Thomas was talking about, just the hustle plays. And it just, I think it really paid off. Every single rebound, you know, every single one of those 15 from Sambila and every single one of, you know, the 36 they had as a team. I think, you know, every single little thing really made a difference in this game.
Fordham did a great job of those little things. Also, just 10 turnovers. And thus, when this has been a team that they've lived and died by turning the basketball over, you go back to Arkansas, 30 total turnovers in that game. You slice that into a third. They've done a great job each game of getting better. And that's been a theme of this coaching staff. They want to improve every single day, playing their best basketball at the end of the year. Well, you look at this one, their most impressive win of the season. There's no doubt when you factor in their opponent. You can't question, well, they're playing their best basketball right now.
Yeah, especially after last year, things were pretty shaky. And, you know, we had our coach Kyle Neptune from last year leave. It was a little bit confusing to in terms of the direction for the team. And it's good to see that the team's 6-1, 6-0 at home, just really having a bounce back that I don't think a lot of people expected from last season.
No, 100%. This win versus Harvard, super impressive to see. And I think, Will, that's just about going to do it for our coverage here today. Fordham, they'll take on Maine Wednesday night back in the Bronx. So we'll see if they can keep the positive vibes going. Fordham wins this one 68, Harvard 60. Want to give a special thanks to our sports director at WFUV, Bobby Chaffredini, as well as everyone involved in today's broadcast. Jack Warner on the highlights, Will Jing with the updates, Nicholas Nappy, our on-site producer, with Thomas Aiello and Michael Calamari on the call. So long from the Bronx. And once again, Fordham men's basketball is a production of WFUV Sports.